What's up, everyone, and welcome to the Monday Night Wolfcast. This is the after Thanksgiving special in which we talk about a lot of things that we did these last few weeks. This is actually podcast number 18. As usual, my name is Wolfie, and today I'm joined by my two friends, Zeromus3.
Hey, what's up, everyone?
And Sinist.
Hello.
So before we get into the gaming news, would you guys like to talk about what you guys did from the last podcast, including Thanksgiving? Who wants to go first? Don't everybody rush up at once, I'll just volunteer. I'll do it.
Okay, fine.
No, you do it.
No, you said you wanted to do it.
You do it. You said okay, so that automatically gets dibs on the storytelling.
Damn, okay.
Get in there.
All right, first thing I did was, Pokemon Sun.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah.
Something tells me we're going to be hearing a lot about this.
We're going to be hearing a lot of this.
About from everyone, but go ahead.
Yeah, Pokemon Sun released the week before. And I got my Pokemon Sun and my Pokemon Moon. Got like the two-pack. The Amazon exclusive one that came with the steel case.
Hang on, I don't mean to interrupt you, but at the time of this recording, that would be 2 weeks ago?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Wait, yes. Would it be 2 weeks? I thought it was last week.
It was 2 weeks ago on the date of this recording.
No, it wasn't.
On the date of this recording, it was 2 weeks ago.
Still wouldn't be accurate with the way you're going for it.
Close enough. Sorry, Scoot. I just wanted to reiterate that this is not at all recorded on any day but Monday. So please continue with your story.
Well, anyways, besides that, I've been playing that, Skyrim, and just to make sure that everyone knows, it was the new Skyrim Special Edition in 4K.
How's that going?
Pretty good.
Just still exactly. As good as it. Like, I haven't played it since it came out, so. To still play well?
Yeah, it does.
Are all the glitches intact?
I don't know about that. I guess they are. I just know it has better draw distance. So you do see more in the background.
Is it 60 frames?
If you're rocking the PC version, that's automatic 60 frames. Oh. But if you're rocking the PlayStation 4 Pro, which that'll be another part of the week, you will have the option to activate 60 frames mode.
Is it locked, or is it like every time you go to a new town or something like that, it like drops?
I don't know. I haven't tested that out. I just got the PS4 version from the Black Friday.
Ah.
I want to say certain areas drop, but
yeah, I assume it's
not completely like 60 frames throughout the whole thing. I think that it's still like unstable in certain areas. That's just my guess. I haven't actually tested it out yet.
Makes sense.
But besides that, I also got a PlayStation 4 Pro. Because I'm pro.
I could have swore you said you got this like the last podcast, but you actually got it during Black Friday?
Like, I put it on layaway, but no, I actually bought it last week. And I've had an on and off experience with the thing. I should probably tell you my worst part about that. On 4K TVs, certain brands, they have issues when you first try to start up the system. All you will ever see is a black screen, and you'll hear the like music. It's a issue with HDCP.
Oh.
And like the TV won't be able to like fully detect the PlayStation until you disable the HDCP. It was something with one of their firmware updates.
I heard and this even. They, oh, go on.
They pushed out another firmware update to fix that, but I still think there's more problems with it. I've had an issue with the PlayStation 4 Pro where, let's say, like I'm playing Street Fighter V, right?
Mm-hmm.
Occasionally, I'll have hiccups when I'm like just doing moves, like as if it was lag. It was really weird. I couldn't explain that.
I heard this is an issue even on like Sony brand TVs.
Yeah, I heard that as well.
Which is
they shouldn't have rushed it.
Yeah, it sounds like it was rushed to market for whatever reason.
They got to get that promo before that pesky Scorpio comes and steals all the sales.
Well, that's still a ways away.
That's too close. They got to get it out now.
I mean, I guess it makes sense to try and get it out before the holiday.
You know Scorpio is probably going to be like $600, $700.
But will it support Ultimate HD DVDs, Blu-rays?
Probably will. It's just something that I don't see the general consumer to go nuts off of.
Worth the price and the wait, if you ask me.
It isn't going to be like anything Nintendo and people, you know, in retail start, you know, having a fist fight over one thing.
No, because Microsoft actually knows how to keep up their stock.
I don't know. You remember the 360?
Yeah, that was their first, second system? I'll give them slack on that.
That was funny.
Their first, second system, huh?
Yeah, their first, second system. Wow. Don't worry about it.
But yeah, it'll never be like anything like that where for some dumb reason there's a fist fight. Because they didn't have enough. And besides that, I've also was playing Dragon Quest again.
Have you actually beaten it this time?
No. I got the next character, and I have to. It's like the same You know, it's the same similarity as you remember Pooh from Earthbound.
Yes.
Where he's like so underleveled.
Yeah. By the time you get him, it's like almost end game, and he's useless. So you have to like grind him up.
Yeah, that's what I'm experiencing right now.
Ah.
And I gotta do the whole job stuff all over again with the new characters. So, like, that's fun, too. And, that's about it, really, for my week.
You want to go next of your week, Bert?
Sure. Do we just all want to talk about Pokemon now?
Yeah, we might as well just...
Since it's all of our weeks.
Yeah, everybody who played Pokemon Sun.
So what'd you think about that, Skids?
Best story Pokemon game in a while.
So you think it's better than like XY and the...
Oh, yes, definitely. XY was disappointing in my...
Even Black and White, which I hear is the best Pokemon game ever made.
Go to hell.
I actually heard that it was pretty good. Is it... Actually,
that's what I wasn't even being facetious. I thought Black and White was heavily regarded as the best Pokemon game since Silver and Gold.
Story wise, it's good, but like mechanics and all that, I wasn't into it.
Hmm. I will
try. Okay. How about this? Put it this way: how do you feel about Black and White? They took all the Pokemon you've ever loved, they threw it at the door, and then they just shoved all the new Pokemon there, and so you forced to use all the new Pokemon.
Oh, you mean like Pokemon Sun?
Actually, Pokemon Sun has
all kinds of stuff, though.
Yeah. It doesn't have my favorites, though.
Oh, no.
It has Growlithe.
Can't please everyone.
Okay, well, fair enough. Growlithe, but what about my...
It has Vulpix.
What about my Tyrantrum? I can't get him.
You have to wait till the Pokebank.
I don't want to wait.
Yeah, well, neither do I.
Yeah, okay. I want to chime in and say, I think at first, when I first started this game, Pokemon Sun, that is, I absolutely hated it.
Why is that?
As soon as the nonstop cutscenes and tutorial stuff, and it just kept going, I started to get that thing where, when I play anything that starts slow and it's an RPG, I start to like, well, I'm like, oof. Oh, yeah, it's doing that thing I don't like, and I'm like,
This is the first one that actually did do that. The other ones never did that.
Yeah, I started glancing at the clock, and I know once I start doing that, I'm like, this game does not have much time to turn around. What is it, like 20 to 30 minutes before you get your starter even? It felt like forever for me, so I hung in there, but... Ooh, that first opening bit. And I had to redo it many times. We'll talk about that later.
I actually enjoyed the ramp up to the intro.
Did you?
Yeah, I didn't have any issues with it.
I didn't have any real issues. I just noticed it. I was like, this is a first.
It's probably the stupid first genre in me, plus I have, like, super impatience. I'd like the first games where it was basically, you wake up, talk to your mom, that's it, go on into the world, and then that's it. You get your starter from the professor, whoever, and then after that, it's just go on your way. This one was like, you took a step. Oh, someone rung the doorbell. Go check who's at the door. Oh, the guy just busted in. Here's more tutorial. Go talk to your mom. Go up the street. And I was like, I just want to go up the town. I just want to go around the island and catch my little Pokemon. And I don't know. I thought it was too slow. It's fun. It's fine now. Now that it's mostly stopped. But that opening bit nearly... If I hadn't bought this game, I probably would have returned it. I was already invested, so I'm like, I'm just going to have to hope this stops sometime soon.
Overall, your experience has been all right now, right?
Yeah, it's fine.
Literally all right now, yeah.
It's fine.
Where are you at in the game?
I just beat myself in the game. The black dude with the fire hair.
That's still in the beginning.
Yeah, I just beat him. I haven't really had much time to play.
That's the second island.
Oh, is that? Okay, yes. Yeah. Bert told me I'm not too far behind him as far as that goes.
Yeah, I'm at the beginning of the third.
Okay. My Popplio is still the best thing ever, and both of you guys can go to hell.
You were saying earlier that you did not like it.
Shut up! He's
fine. All I remember is when we showed you Oshawa, you were like... This Pokemon's dumb. I don't like seal Pokemon. And then we just like...
No, I said I don't like the Nintendo seal of quality. That's what I said. No, so yeah, that's a lie.
Try to cover it up. I see how it is.
It's a good lie. What you guys are saying, that is. Not what I said, what you guys said.
Weren't you, whenever you got that Totodile, you're like, oh, this will replace some things, right?
I said it would replace some things. I never said what they would replace. Yeah. There's room in my heart for plenty of water Pokemon in this party. Popplio, Totodile, let's go. But Bert, how are you enjoying your starter, your Litten, by the way? How's your experience of Pokemon going?
My Litten, or I guess it's not a Terracat, is very bad now. Because I've been not evolving it.
Uh-huh. Why don't you explain why you haven't been evolving it?
Because that last form is awful.
So there you have it, guys. If you if you disagree with Bert, please tell him in the comments how much of an idiot he is.
You know the best thing is?
What's that?
Incineroar looks like a freaking, wrestler, right?
Yeah.
You think he'd be a fighting type, but he's a fire dark, right?
Yeah.
Guess what his weakness is? It's fighting.
Oh, that is super ironic.
That's really hilarious.
If you really think about it, a fighter is a wrestler's weakness, because a wrestler doesn't really know how to take those hits hard.
That's a little meta, but yeah.
Yeah.
I can see that.
Pokemon Sun, right now, where I'm at, I already beat the Elite Four. I'm doing the post-game right now. In the post-game, I hate anything that is fighting. Anything that is fighting at the moment.
So... Sorry. The thing I want to point out here, the reason Bert is a dumb idiot, is because he doesn't like wrestling, and he also doesn't like fire, and he also, I guess he doesn't like cats anymore because he refuses to evolve his fire cat into what it truly was meant to be. You can't ask Pikachu your fire Litten. You gotta let that thing evolve and then Darkest Lariat your opponents.
No way.
Yes.
I will replace it before I evolve it.
You know, the worst thing is Pikachu can get away with it.
Yeah. Everybody likes Pikachu. He's the mascot. You're Litten as shit, Bert.
I agree. The way it is.
Scoots evolved his into a fucking wrestler. What did you call yours, by the way, Scoots? If it's not a wrestler name, I'm going to be really disappointed.
Well, my Incineroar is called King.
Okay, that's fair.
King of the Beast!
That is acceptable.
Named Elblaze.
Oh my god, that's also really good. Did you call yours that, Bert?
No, I don't have a fire wrestling cat.
You're dumb.
He'll never evolve it.
That's fine.
I told him, why don't you just rock the Cyndaquil?
You should trade me your Scoots. I need the Pokédex data.
Just evolve one of the many Littens you have, you idiot.
That's why I was leveling one of those up with the others, the Popplio and the Rowlet.
Oh my god. Dumb.
So dumb.
It is dumb, I agree.
Yeah. Look at my Popplio. She's almost on the way to becoming full Little Mermaid, and I'm gonna embrace her when she does. It's fine.
Yeah, Everstone. You know what, Bert? You know what you should have rocked? You should have rocked the damn owl.
You might as well have.
You should have went without it.
Probably, but it was a cat. How could I not choose it?
Because you're not letting the cat become what it needs to be. Fire Pro Wrestler.
You're not giving
it... It's what I need it to be.
Uh-huh.
That's all that matters.
You know what you could have done, Bert? Actually, you know what? You could have looked for those items that boost specific stats as you level up. You keep it equipped to your Pokemon.
Yeah, well, like mine's already maxed out on all that EV stuff. And it's all just all over the place because he's just been killing everything. And he's just real bad at this point.
Because that's what I was doing to my Snivy when I was leveling it up.
Yeah, if I ever went to re-level up one, I would do correct stats, but I don't really care while going through the story.
Speaking of story...
You have become number one Pokemon breeder!
Bird is now a Pokemon breeder.
I've wonder traded about 50 Littens.
So, let me ask you something. How does it feel to be a Pokemon breeder? Does it make you feel happy in the inside when you're doing it and making dittos go into overdrive?
They only go into overdrive until I get another female. And then I do same type. Without having to beat in the game, I can't see what their actual stats are. Because I think you unlock that after you beat it and you get the computer to tell you what their actual good stats are. So I just have a bunch of stuff. I have no idea if they're any good or not.
Oh.
So I just wonder trade them all. And it makes me happy that the
world gets a bunch of Littens. It would be funny if you actually wonder traded like the best Litten ever. Like the most amazing
stats. At least they're Littens. It could have been like you trading a whole bunch of Magikarp to people.
Oh, I have so many garbage Pokemon from doing that.
Pokemon and actual garbage.
And that was from Scoots.
You're welcome. You love that Trubbish. Like, you love your trash.
Speaking of trash, could we please all have a moment to talk about how great Team Skull is? I've only seen them very few times, and I love every time they show up.
I thought you were going to go somewhere else with the trash thing, but all right.
Oh.
I was going to tell you a trash story that happened today.
Is it about Pokemon while we're on the subject?
No, it involves just parking at Walmart, and then apparently customers just freaking leave trash in front of my vehicle, giant trash bags, and I don't see it, and I move forward, I hit the damn thing.
Very irresponsible.
Poor Trubbish.
Yeah, that Trubbish never knew what hit him.
Yeah, it's okay. Becomes the awesome thing they call garbage or door. I cannot say that in the Pokemon's name, but... The Pokemon makes the best noise ever.
So what do you think of Team Skull?
Team Skull is amazing. This is probably my favorite team so far. Their dialogue is very cringy, but I just love their theme.
Whenever they leave, it like changes to that. I don't know how to describe it.
What, the theme?
Yeah, like when they leave, it switches to a different thing.
Does it really?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
You like the fact that their theme is so hard.
Their theme is amazing. It's just so hard. I love that whenever they walk, they're fucking just like everything about
them. They're beatboxing.
Yeah, they're animated. Their animations are amazing. I just don't like their dialogue as much.
It's so good. Or so bad. It's good.
Yeah, it's like every time they show up, I'm like, oh fuck, here he goes. I do wish they were a little bit more of a threat. I mean, where I'm at in the story, they're not a threat, and we're still, like, making jokes and shit on them, like, I don't know who you are, and they're like, what? But yeah, every time they show up, I just, like, I put the 3DS down for a bit and just, like, jam out to their theme. It's amazing. I love them. I hope they actually become a threat later on, though.
You should hear the boss version of that, like, the head boss of Team Skull's, his battle theme. That's pretty good.
I like their battle theme, too. It's not bad. Overall, on the music department in this game, it's kind of forgettable for me. Like, the only theme I actually memorize right now is Team Skull, and that's because I just love that theme so much.
Well, I mean, all the battle themes are pretty good, in my opinion.
Yeah, I guess they sound really similar, and I guess that's on purpose, but after a while, you've heard, like, you know, that same kind of instruments, that same kind of melody it always has for every Pokemon battle in almost every game. It's very similar throughout all of them.
For me, all I'm hearing right now is the Ultra Beast theme. And that's interesting.
And also, can we talk about how shit the rival is in this game?
We got two rivals.
That kid or whoever?
Yeah. At least, I don't know.
Why do you get the Pokemon that's weak to you? I thought you were supposed to get the one that's better than yours.
He's helping you out.
I would tell you, but then that would ruin everything.
All right. As of where I'm at in the story, he's pretty shit.
He's always.
and the girl with that really annoying Pokemon thing in the bag can go to hell, too. I really don't like the story. I guess I'll say that much right now.
Dang.
I don't like the story characters. They're not doing anything for me, except for the professor. When I saw him...
Of course you like him.
It all made sense once I saw... Is that a spoiler if I say anything? But when you see the professor at a certain place, and I saw him like that, I was like, okay, mm-hmm. I really like him now. Everything makes sense, especially why he talks like that and everything. I was like, I'm on board. I want a game about this guy. But no, the rival is not doing anything for me. I don't know what the girl's purpose is.
Did you even fight the other rival yet? So that one's the better rival.
There's another rival? Oh, is it that weird... God, I don't even know. I don't know what classifies as spoilers. Is it... I probably know who you're talking about.
You know who it is.
Yeah, okay.
I didn't know that was a rival.
I didn't know that was a rival. I assume that was just...
Wow.
Sub-boss.
He's technically your second rival, but like, I guess you only see him like three times. You encounter him three times, but he is throughout the whole story there.
Okay. Hopefully the story gets better. I mean, for me, it's like, right now. So don't think I'm just shitting on it because I don't like RPGs in general, and I have shit taste when it comes to these things, so...
Between Island 2 and 3, it got pretty interesting.
Does it?
It throws a new wrinkle in anyway.
Okay, good.
I thought it was kind of interesting, but we'll see where that goes.
Let me ask you something, Bert. When you got to the third island, did you get your ass kicked?
No.
Because that's apparently where the learning curve...
The difficulty curve
comes in.
I got the electric badge. I think that's the first one you get there.
You mean the electric trial?
And I'm down by the... shopping mart, I guess, to the south. Unless it gets harder from there, I don't know. But I've had no issues so far.
He's been too busy breeding.
That too.
Okay, I feel I want to clear the air by saying things I actually did like with the game, because I feel like I just, like...
Oh, we gotta go through one more thing, the worst part of the game.
Oh, what's that?
It's the freaking SOS system, the call for help.
Oh my god, okay, yeah.
It's that so needs bad. To be addressed. Like, what the hell were they thinking?
That, okay, I already told you guys this earlier, but I'll tell all the listeners. I had a, like, 30 to 45 minute epic life and death struggle with a fucking Zubat, because it kept calling for help, and it would not stop. I just kill its ally, and then it would attack me, and then call for help, and then rinse and repeat. I was actually, this will tie into what happens later on, what I'll talk about later on, what I was doing in my week. But I was doing something while fighting the Zubat at the same time, and I got really frustrated, and I didn't want to run away or just anything at that point, because I was like, no, it's a matter of principle. This thing must die now. It's wasted 30 minutes of my life, and it's gonna die. It did eventually, but
the SOS system is actually pretty good for like. Leveling up your Pokemon, in my opinion.
It's also good for getting a Pokemon that you don't normally see, because sometimes they'll call for help and something new will fall up. You're like, you just doomed yourself. I was going to catch you, but now I'm going to fucking kill you and get that thing.
But, that whole SOS system made me always keep a Pokemon that knows sleep on me.
Yeah. That's what I had to do after a while, because it just got so annoying when I was trying to catch things.
I could be a scumbag and use the move First Impression. People who's played Sun and Moon knows what I'm talking about. Not you, Bert. You haven't reached that point.
Yeah, I have no idea what that is.
Neither do I.
You're going to love that move. You too, Justin.
Probably will.
Love that move.
I like the move Astonish, just because the animation is hilarious.
Oh, are they like back up? Yeah. Or is that the one where he spins around?
Yeah, it's like they kind of like turn around like do 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 do, and they turn around and it's fucking like flashes. It's so good. I like it. It's like astonished, and they're like, and they get hurt by it somehow.
First impression is the most scumbag move in the game, at the moment.
I don't know. Sleep never works for me. They always like fall asleep for one thing, and then they wake up immediately after. They never stay asleep for like more than one turn.
Mine's always pretty long.
Just be prepared for it, Bert. Be prepared, because it's gonna change your whole outlook of difficulty.
And life.
And everything.
Yeah, the way to fix SOS, I think, would just have it cost a move, yeah?
Yeah, like, why don't let them use a move and then immediately turn. Use it after.
Like, I understand its usefulness for training and all that stuff, and it's kind of cool to have, you know, like a dynamic engagement sometimes, like something new happens. But I don't know, that SOS thing is crazy. It's like, what were they doing when they were playtesting that?
It works too well. Like, the success rate of them calling for help should be 50-50. Or 25-75 in our favor.
It's probably around that. We're just
it's just unlucky. You get the unlucky coin flip every time, and they keep getting help.
Yeah, it's just more annoying than anything.
And Bert, you did say something that caught my ear a little bit earlier. You said RPGs you like things that mix it up a little bit in battle.
We're not going into this.
Kind of like Shin Megami Tensei and the demon talking system.
That's completely different.
I believe that is exactly the same and probably awesome.
It's completely different.
No, it's pretty good. But I'll let you continue on with your little week here. What else in Pokemon Sun have you enjoyed thus far?
I played Titanfall 2. That game was way better than it should have been.
I heard it's really, really good. It's just not like they released it at a bad time, so the population's not really there.
On PC, apparently, it's pretty dead, or like some of the game modes, you just can't get matches, which is a shame. Right.
That's very sad.
PS4 was fine. I don't know about Xbox. I'm sure they probably have more just because that's where the first game was, but I have no idea.
And that's where most of the population of FPS people are anyways, is Xbox.
True.
Yeah, I'm not sure how it shook out this generation. But the campaign was surprisingly good for when you think about shooter campaigns. I don't know. People were comparing it to like Half-Life 2. I don't think they should go that far.
What is it up there?
It is, but like not like Half-Life 2 was something that like changed the like used new tech and changed like what first person shooters or like games in general with their engine, with their physics engine.
I should probably play that game one day. I hear it's really good.
Half-Life 2?
Yeah.
I mean
it occasionally pops up in like when people talk about games. I don't think I've really heard much about it, but I should try it sometime. Apparently that might be really good.
I mean, you'll never get to see the cliffhanger end because they're never going to make a new one.
No, it's fine. Halfway through, I'll just stop. I'll just be like, oh, there you go. Yeah, this is a great game. I think I've had my fill.
Yeah, I don't know really what to say about Titanfall 2 without spoilers, but they put in mechanics that normally first-person games don't have. But yeah,
why don't you go ahead and name just one then?
I can't because people should play it if they want to see it.
So, huge recommendation from you, Bert.
I would say that, but not if you're just going to play the like campaign, because obviously you probably just want to rent it or something. But if you're a first-person shooter fan, like give it a go. But apparently the population's not doing so well, so... And there's been a lot of deals, so maybe with the Black Friday stuff happening, maybe there'll be more people playing.
So, Bert.
Hmm?
What about the other first-person shooter game that you played?
Talking about Overwatch?
Yeah.
We did play it.
We did.
Surprisingly enough, we did. We actually stuck to our guns. I did not record it though because I'm an idiot.
We won quite a few of those. I think we lost maybe twice out of like 10, 12 games.
12 or something, yeah. Very surprising considering.
Yeah. What did you play this on?
PlayStation PS4. 4. Because I was not going to make him play the PC version with a controller.
Nope.
That would be awful
that
for him.
That would be horrible.
Since he doesn't play shooters to begin with.
They say your body resets every 7 years. And considering my birthday was a week or so ago, I've been trying out different things. And oh, sorry, I don't mean to hijack it, but yeah, Bert and I did play Overwatch together.
You usually don't play shooters.
Nope.
Except for Splatoon, I think.
And Doom.
For multiplayer. Well, I'm talking about multiplayer.
Oh, right.
But yeah, you obviously play Doom and Aliens, Colonial Marines.
We don't talk about that one.
For whatever reason.
We don't talk about that one. That was our Valentine's Day special game. And I severely regret it.
All I remember was Bert locking you in the room.
I remember us both getting the business at some point.
That was the best thing I've ever seen Bert do.
Yeah, that wasn't really nice too, considering that was like the first person game I'd played like since high school, whenever that Quake game or whatever was out.
I remember the stream. They lost it when Bert did that.
Yeah, I'm surprised you guys kept watching that stream, considering it was from my viewpoint.
Yeah, all I remember was.
God.
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
I was gonna say the one time you got play of the game, it was very nauseating.
Yeah, the one where I just went hammer crazy on everyone. Uh-huh. Oh my god, the camera was so erratic. Just like me, just turn around. Oh, is there someone there? Die. You die.
That so you were playing Reinhardt, yeah? That was his name.
That was it. That's the only character I played was Reinhardt, and you played
Mercy.
Mercy. Healer.
So I was keeping you guys alive, so pretty you could much. Swing your hammer around like a crazy person.
Then I wouldn't die as fast.
Except for when your shield exploded.
Because the fucking turret guy or whatever would just mow me down. Every
He's
time.
Bad news.
Yep.
Since you have issues with perception in first-person games, you were having issues with Tracer.
Yep.
She was all over.
Oh my god, fuck that character. Because, teleportation behind me is the worst thing ever, because as soon as you leave my vision, my viewpoint in first person, I panic and I start like, where the fuck are they? And I start turning around quickly. And while I'm doing that, like, it's just, I'm getting shot all over the place and it gets worse and I start panicking more. I don't like not knowing where I'm being hit.
A nice addition that you noticed first was the, characters calling out behind you.
Yes. This is an amazing thing for people like me who suck at first-person shooters. I noticed that, in particular, whenever, especially I was playing Reinhardt, and I had the shield up, and people would be behind me, and say, that mech chick would, like, teleport through my shield, and I'd be like, whoa, okay, what the fuck happened? And all of a sudden, the character voice would be like, behind you! And I turn around, and they're right there, and I'm like, that is amazing. I don't know what genius decided to have characters say, like, if someone's behind you shooting you, but that is a great audio cue for someone like me who just loses track of people very easy. So I didn't really die as much as I usually do in first-person shooters.
Yeah.
It might have been also because of Bert's healing influence, but...
Well, you had your shield up most of the time. Like, I don't know what it is with Reinhardt, but as soon as that shield went down, you just dropped. Like, I'm curious if it does something. Like, you take more damage if you break your shield.
I'm pretty sure every time you saw my shield go down, it's because I was being turreted.
Well, still, you would die instantly.
Exactly. If you saw from my point of view, whenever it shows like this player killed you and showed the replay, it would just be some guy with the turret turning into a turret, and just my shield disappears, and all of a sudden I just die. It was just like that.
Yeah.
It could have been that.
But yeah, overall, that game's a lot of fun.
It was super fun. Like, I was the whole time I was sitting there smiling, having fun, and like we're laughing, and like this is the first like first person shooter game that we played together that we're not screaming at each other. Like, and we played Splatoon earlier, and like that got messy, but like this.
Well, it gets messy because Splatoon doesn't let you stick with your same team.
That is true. So sometimes we'd be on opposing sides, and we'd have to kill each other.
Mm-hmm. And then we just spend time chasing each other around the map.
Pretty much. That was just the game was us trying to kill each other while everybody else was having a paint war and occasionally killing people that got in our way.
Yep.
But this game, it was fucking fun. I don't know. I definitely pick this one up. Should the opportunity arise when it's very cheap, I'll probably wind up getting it. But that was really fun. I would love to learn like other characters, but Reinhardt himself is an amazingly fun character for me to use that doesn't require good aim.
Yeah. And you can like play the objective where you could like set up your shield and help everyone else still.
Be a fucking meat shield.
Even if you can't necessarily be the best shooter and aiming type thing.
As long as I'm there, people live.
Except for when you run ahead with everyone and our point gets taken.
That was fine, though. Everything worked out. We still won that match. We still won it.
We won most of them.
Yeah. The only thing that really killed, like, the same thing that killed you and I at the same time was every time you were trying to heal me, you'd be, like, right behind me, and that fucking wheel guy, that trash guy, would throw the wheel, and it would just detonate my foot and then take you out at the same time.
Yeah.
I kept thinking I could block it, but I couldn't.
I was surprised you could block D.Va's ultimate where her mech explodes.
Yeah, me too.
I was expecting you to just die. Nope. But everyone behind you got to survive. That was kind of cool.
It was really cool. Had great moments like that. Overwatch is really fun. Really fun. Glad we played it.
Mm-hmm.
This is the game that you would recommend other people to play.
Yes.
Of course, yeah.
If you like shooters at all. Team shooters, definitely.
Maybe if you don't like shooters, apparently.
Oh, yeah, me too. Yeah, because I don't like shooters, and I really like that one. It seems to be a character for everybody and everybody's play style in there, so...
And they just keep adding more, so... Like, Sombra was first out, like, during that weekend.
Yeah.
So we saw a few of them, but I have no idea if they're any good or not, because that was our first time playing.
Yep, that's probably my surprise, like... No, I'll say Doom was my first surprise game of the year, but this is definitely a second surprise game of the year. I was expecting to pick this up, play it for like two matches, get really mad at Bert, and then tell him to fuck off, and then turn the game off and delete it.
That's what I was expecting.
Yep, but then sticking with it. That was really fun.
I was all like, "Whoa, this doesn't compute."
He's actually enjoying a shooter game.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Me too. Bert got a lot of. Got a lot of the, what do you call that when at the end when it tells like everybody the top four players?
Oh, like the healing done, shield?
Yeah, you mostly got the like always like top healing every single time.
Yeah, he's Mercy.
Yeah. That's true. I don't think there were really other healing characters.
Well, not on our team. Usually you only want one.
Oh, okay. I don't think the other team even have one either.
Yeah, they used some, like there's a few Zenyattas. I don't know how he functions though.
Oh.
But yeah, it was... Good time.
You're a super good healer, except when fucking chasers and everything come after your ass and they try to kill you.
Yeah, well, there's not really much I can do to
just fend those people off. You just hear him say, help, and I'm like turning around and I see a fucking chaser pursuing his ass, trying to kill him. He's like doing evasive maneuvers and shit. That was really good.
Yeah. I would like to talk more about like Dishonored 2, because that's another game I played.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
But... I couldn't play too much of it because it made me motion sick.
Oh, did you act? So is it gone now?
No, I still have it, but like I really wanted to enjoy that because the first game was so good.
Mm-hmm.
But something about this one, and I don't think it's the frame. Well, I know it's the frame rate that gets me, but it's stable 30, so that's fine for most people.
Right.
But
it's just when you're moving really fast, and
it's not even that because you, like, you're crouching and walking most of the time, like.
I was gonna say, this is a man who played Mirror's Edge, a first person fucking.
Well, that game's in 60. That's what the issue is. I don't know. It just makes me motion sickness, and I start feeling not great, and I just can't play it anymore.
so you have the Devil May Cry 2 did to me.
I guess
just made me sick. I've never been sick playing a game before, but that's the only one that's ever made me like physically ill, and I started feeling I'm going to put this controller down and just sit this one out for a bit.
It's a real shame.
Yeah. But you did play the game the right way before you got sick, right?
No, of course I did. No killing.
Okay, so therein lies the problem. If you would kill people, the frame rate would increase, thus making the playthrough better for you. It's bogged down by the amount of people you left alive.
I don't think so.
I'm pretty sure.
I think it works that way.
The bodies would still be there.
I think they'd fade away.
Chuck them all over, like, into the river.
Exactly. Get rid of them. Have the bodies despawn, so that way you can just...
I'm not saying the frame rate dips or anything. I think it's a solid 30. But, like, first-person games at 30, I don't think I can do anymore.
Hmm. I'm trying to think of any first person shooters we played recently. You played Alien Colonial Marines 5.
Yeah, I also played like Dishonored 1 on that same system.
Yeah, those were 30, right?
Yeah.
Weird.
Like, I used to be okay with that as long as it was stable. But something about this, just, I can't do it.
Hmm. So you probably won't be revisiting this anytime soon.
Probably revisit it one more time, see what happens. Otherwise, I'm done with it.
So if, let's say I got it for you on the PC, do you think you could be able to play?
Well, seeing how the PC version's busted, no one can get it to run properly.
Good old whoever made this.
Good. At least I got that out of the door.
Yeah, apparently anyone who has it on PC, they've been trying to patch it. I don't know if they've gotten it to where it needs to be yet. Maybe by the time they think we're recording this, it's fixed.
Yeah, you know, on the day we're actually recording, yeah, who knows? Yeah, today it could even happen on Monday.
Heck, maybe.
Who knows?
In the last game I played, if you want to talk about poor frame rates, Valkyria Azure Revolution.
I was so curious to hear your opinions on this. We've been shitting
that game
on this one.
Has the worst frame rate I think I've ever played.
Worse than Dishonored 2.
Dishonored 2 is solid.
Oh, God.
But, like, it gets worse than Drakengard 3 at times.
Oh, my. Wow. Don't say that.
Like, holy wow. Crap.
No way.
So does it go, like, 5 frames then?
I just had to stop looking at one
slideshow?
Point.
Slideshow?
It's just... That's not that bad, but it stays there.
It
doesn't go back up.
it gets lower and just stays there. It keeps going lower.
If it goes down, it's like, I'm not getting back up.
Nope, that's it.
The only thing that makes it playable is the fact that they made it so, like, whenever you're going to cast abilities or, like, use a gun, it turns into, like, regular Valkyrie. Like,
Where everything kind of...
Chronicles.
Freeze frames.
Yeah, where everything stops.
Yeah.
So the frame rate comes back up.
that's the way to refresh the frame rate. Go into menu and get your gun ready. That's a mechanic, like, actually, for the game.
Apparently.
Oof.
Yeah, that's... I don't know about that game, man. Like, that game is not coming to the West if it does not improve with this next demo. Like, this is the 2.0 demo that I played. Apparently, they're going to have a new one this next month.
They're really pushing for this game, so yeah, I think it's this month coming up.
If they don't improve that frame rate, man, like, holy crap.
That does not fill me with optimism to hear you say this. You and I being Valkyria Chronicles nut jobs, and hearing that this game is not good does not fill me with hope.
Yeah, so they try to make it more action-y. So
okay,
the game's
yeah.
just in real time. You run around like a third-person hack and slash, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Except when you go up to attack, it, like, I don't know, it's like choosing a combo, or like in an RPG, you have a turn-based thing where you use, like, attacks.
Right.
Like, you press X once and your character will start doing the melee stuff. Like, it's not like a Devil May Cry or anything like that.
Oh.
They have a set combo that you press the button, like, you want to attack, so they go up and do it. They even choose the target themselves.
Oh.
And then you have to wait for a little bar to refill before you can use another action.
Oh.
It's so I don't understand why they wanted this to be a third person action game.
Oh.
Like, the best parts of the game are when you're aiming your gun, like Valkyrie, or you're casting spells, like the Shining games, I guess.
Oh boy.
Justin's soul is getting crushed.
Oh. I don't understand what they're trying to do with this.
I don't know either, dude. Like, just hearing you say these, like, at first I thought it was just going to be like, oh, it's just a generic Tales of, like, you know,
no.
Star Ocean type deal where you just run around and kind of, you know.
That's what I thought it was going to be at first. And then I was pressed X and the character just swung and then I had to wait for a bar to fill again.
That
I was like,
sounds
well, okay.
Horrible. What the fuck are they doing?
I don't know.
Why? Valkyria Chronicles was fine. It didn't need this.
The
it
best parts of this game are the things that they take from that. You can even hide behind cover.
Yep,
for whatever reason.
Point the gun, restore the frame rate, shoot.
Yeah, or use a spell. Because
oh
you use
God.
Ragnite to cast spells now.
Oh
I will say one
God.
Thing.
Okay.
They made the Valkyrie.
Uh-huh.
Like, they made them seem extremely powerful. Because holy crap, I could not beat that thing.
That's good.
Nah, I mean, if the frame rate was better than 5.
But like, oh no. Like, the one thing they got right is you can't mess that up. Because you remember, you could not kill the Valkyrie in the first game either. She shows up, she wrecks your shit, and then leaves.
Mm-hmm.
You couldn't even hurt her.
This one has, like, magic and stuff now.
Oh, God. Does she have, like, that cool that thing in the cool trailer where she sings and everybody fucking dies?
No, but one of your characters has the thing where they sing and everyone gets healed.
Oh, great. They totally stole that from the fucking new Shining games.
Well, this is very much a mix between the Shining games, the newer versions, and Valkyrie. Which I was going to ask you, do you know what studio is making this?
The Wild Arms Studio, I think.
The Wild Arms Studio? What was the last thing they made?
Fantasy Star... I want to say Nova. Or it might have been the last Shining game. Yeah, oh wait, you're right, that's Tri-Ace. Then I think it was one of the old the Shining games on PSP.
I guess that would make sense.
Yeah.
Also, the game, like, doesn't look great, obviously, because it's going to be on a Vita also. Like, everything is flat, like the terrain and stuff.
Oh, just like the barren open world looking thing.
Like, it's like the geometry is real low, but it has a decent art style, so it kind of makes up for it, but not really. Most Japanese games that don't have a budget, I guess you'd say. I don't know. I really wanted to like that game, and there's aspects in there that are fun, but there's just so much that brings it down.
You know, Vert, even if this game does come over, after that, what you just said there, don't think I'd have to pick it up just to show support, but at the same time, fuck.
I wouldn't buy it at all unless it was on PC so that maybe the frame rate would be okay.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Or they fix it. Like, I don't know how... I mean, a lot of Japanese games have poor frame rates. It's just how they do things now.
That's how they do.
And usually that's okay if it's a turn-based game. You get over it. Whatever.
How about that PlayStation 4 Pro, then?
Oh, God. Yeah. If they're like, hey, you want to get the Pro, have this Vita game run at 60, let's do it. Or maybe a solid 30, let's go.
Oh, man.
I don't know. I wanted this game to be good. I wanted it to come over, but...
Bert. There's
very little hope for any of that, and Bert. I don't know if I'd care.
Bert. I want you to be honest with me. Did you really want this game to be good?
Of course. Of course you want it to be good.
Like, the first time you saw the trailer, you were like... Uh-huh. You looked over to me with, like, the sad eyes, and you were like, I don't know about this one.
I know. Doesn't mean I didn't want it to be good.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure. That is sad. I'm glad I didn't take the time set up my Japanese account to get the demo.
I'll play the new one just to see if it's different. Oh. But man, like if they want to save money, they should not bring it to the West.
Good news, Bert. It's probably not coming to the West.
Yeah.
Well, besides that disappointing tidbit there, anything else you did this week?
No, that was the last thing I did.
Okay. Well, I guess I will go ahead and talk about my week, and there's really not much else to talk about because we already talked about Pokemon Sun and Overwatch.
You said you were doing something while playing Sun.
That's the last thing here. And finally, guys, it happened. I've snapped. I am no longer watching The Walking Dead TV show on AMC. I'm done. I'm finished. I have thrown in the towel.
Let me ask you, why is this? What made you snap?
Okay, so here's the thing.
Was it Popplio? And you're like, I'm done?
No, it was it's okay, so here's how I initially got started to Walking Dead. I read the comics on and off a long time ago, long ass time ago. Right around the time they started putting the TV show on the air. We didn't really have AMC. That was back when we were in Illinois. So I saw the box set. It was the first season and the second season. I was like, huh, so this is based on that comic I used to read. Let me go ahead and pick these up. We'll make something out of this. We'll make like a cheesy zombie movie night. So my sister and I used to watch them like every night we'd watch an episode. And we were like, oh my God, this is actually not bad. I thought this was going to be like a B-movie like type show about zombies. But no, it actually turned out to be really good. The first two seasons, second season kind of blew. But the first season, Jesus. That was really good. So we kind of got hooked on that, and I've been watching it ever since. We are now 7 seasons in, and I'm done. So you're probably asking, what was the straw that broke the camel's back? And remember how a couple podcasts ago I said I was already kind of finished and done after the whole, the way they botched the Negan reveal thing, who died? Yeah. It has not been the same since. Like, I was so unemotionally invested. And it's gotten to the point where the show, there was a kind of goal after the, you know, the first season's kind of had a goal to it. Like, we're the Walking Dead. We're going to go ahead and try to see if we can survive this thing. And see if we can find a CDC, like, to see if they've found any new thing on this virus or whatever. Whatever's causing the zombie outbreak. And the end of the first season, they get to the CDC and they find out, oh, wait, we're all just actually just infected. And as soon as we die, oh, we just become zombies. That's the thing. There's no cure. That's it. We're fucked. And that was kind of it. And then they teased in this fifth season that there was going to be an end goal. They have to get to Washington, D.C., to get to like this safe bunker thing, and they were gonna live out the rest of the zombie apocalypse there. I guess I can go ahead and say spoiler for this, but because this is like fifth season stuff, but turns out that was a lie. That character was lying, and then there's no goal again. The whole thing has just been depression porn. It really is. There's nothing happens. It's just we're gonna go to this area. All right, we've taken this area over. Let's try to make a civilization. Oh no, bad people are coming to challenge our civilization. Let's kill them. We kill them. Let's go to another let's go to another place and set up another civilization because they blew up our last one. That's been the same running thing on and off for seven seasons, and I can't take anymore.
So
I can't do it.
If you wanted the show to end, how would you have it end? Like, what are you wanting to see concluded?
That was another reason I just quit, because there's no end in sight for this thing. It's just the never-ending pattern of just do this thing, kill the bad guy, do this thing, kill the bad guy, do this thing. So for me, how I would end that show, because as of now, there's no real end goal anywhere, I would try to have it to the point where, like, they set themselves up after they kill final big bad, whoever it may be, but they finally get themselves set up in like a kind of hut or whatever, you know? They start building around them, start building themselves up, and they kind of, it's not a happily ever after, but it's like a, we can live like this. We can grow our own stuff, we can, you know, we're safe here, that sort of thing. Kind of how season 2 of Walking Dead's Telltale ended, if you did a certain ending. Like, you can go and hole up back at the giant supermarket, and you can decide to hole up and build up there. Something like that would be okay. Or just have everybody die, but, like, the kid characters, and have them be like, we're gonna try to survive this, the rest of this thing, and for a better future, and all that. There's
in the new season.
Exactly, yeah. Like, it's okay, but I'm no longer invested. At this point, I don't care about the characters. They've butchered everybody from the way they're portrayed in the comics. Negan's not even fun to watch anymore as a villain, and that's bad because that's, like, he is the villain of Walking Dead. So if I'm not even, like, invested in the bad guy or the characters, I'm not watching this for fun anymore. It's not fun to watch. I was playing my 3DS the entire time the last episode was on, and they had an hour and 30 minutes special in which nothing happened. Nothing happened. And I was like, this is fucking stupid. I'm done. So I'm done. Me and my sister are no longer watching this anymore. And I'm
sad.
Have
the comics concluded? Or are they still
going? No, it's still going.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And that's kind of why it's like, well, they're never going to end this anytime soon.
Well, I'll find something else to watch. It's probably making
money, yeah? Yeah, I hear the ratings have been dropping, like, bad ever since the season premiere. After after spoiler happens when certain character dies in the premiere, they say the ratings kind of tapered off and they've been dropping since. So, no skin off my nose. I'm officially done. I'm gonna find something else to watch every Sunday now.
You sure? You gotta give it one more chance?
Nope. That was last week when I was playing Pokemon Sun during it. It was so boring. Nothing happened.
Maybe it was because you were playing Sun.
No.
Maybe if you were just fully...
No, Bert.
Okay.
No. Okay, I feel good now that I got that out of my chest. Been enjoying Pokemon Sun. Really liked Overwatch. Haven't really done much else. I survived Black Friday. And yeah. That's I think that's gonna go ahead and I got a new seat for my birthday. I got a new chair.
Oh, is this what you're referring to earlier?
Yeah. I was really happy about that. It's the same material as the last one, so in about a year or two it's gonna start peeling and flaking and shit.
That's how it goes.
But you know, it's nice now. I didn't realize that after sitting in this new one and my old one, like there's supposed to be like a bit of fluff and poof to it when you sit down.
Yeah.
Like air's supposed to shoot out of it. When I sat on my old one, it was just like sitting on like a fucking wood board. There was no poof, it was just like I felt like my fucking tailbone like collide with like whatever was inside that once poofy leathery material. And I was like, this is very painful. I don't know how I used to sit on this thing. So Bert, you should probably get your chair replaced soon. You're probably hurting your back. You're probably really hurting your back. I didn't realize how bad it was until I sat on this new seat. But I'm like really paranoid now, so I have like a fucking like throw blanket thrown over it so I don't fucking start peeling it immediately.
Careful, as it heats up, it's gonna start peeling.
Oh no! The blanket's coming off. All right then. Other than that, had a good birthday. I got really really passionate about it. Let's go into the gaming news. So guys, we need to talk about something very important here.
Is it gaming related?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's about porn and Nintendo. Oh. It has to stop. The Nintendo porn has to stop. So, Nintendo, the master of the DMCAs, the thing they love to issue out to fans and fan-made games, they've decided that porn made of particular Nintendo characters has to stop. So, they're handing them out now. And this is posted from a... Yep. This is posted from a guy on NeoGAF, but apparently he got a claim... Or not a... What's this? What are these things called again? What's that?
DMCA takedown notice?
Yeah, takedown notice. Of some lewd arts he had made of Nintendo characters. Right now, they're apparently going after people who are drawing Peach and Zelda. So, all you lewd artists out there, be careful. Nintendo's on a fucking takedown notice right now. They're going ham. The reason this is important is because it's only on Tumblr right now, from what's being said in this thread. It's like people on Tumblr are getting these things, but like they're saying it's not unlike Overwatch, where they were using the actual like source, you know, what's that thing called? The 3D program that they use for like videos on YouTube now. Source something, whatever. They were using 3D assets from Overwatch and making porn out of them. So yeah. Overwatch, you know, the people
source
they were
filmmaker.
Yeah, they were obviously taking that down, so that makes sense, but this is like drawn stuff. Things that Nintendo... I don't know if you can do that. But it's fine. So,
I was gonna say, fan art is acceptable, but like porn is not.
Exactly.
There.
Yeah.
It's a better way to put it.
I don't... So what this means is soon all the Nintendo porn will be purged from the net. They know how it works.
Good luck.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, good by luck. Doing this, Nintendo, you have opened the floodgates. Now, if you ever piss off an artist, that's the worst thing you want to do, because that's when it starts getting crazy.
Good luck.
Yep. Did you see on this thread the tweet? I don't know if this is actually Shigeru Miyamoto, but the tweet reads, saw a picture of Mario and Luigi kissing one another online. Please do not do that. It's hilarious if that is actually an actual tweet. I doubt it is, but
that is funny.
That's fucking hilarious. Could you just imagine though, being a creator and seeing your creations just fucking doing it?
How the heck do you think the Dead or Alive guy feels?
I'm sure he's okay with that. Considering what he does to his own creations, I'm pretty sure he's okay with that.
He says it like damages.
Oh, like shut the hell up. No way. Did he actually say that?
He actually did make a claim about that, say something about it. It's kind of like something about like their like his daughters.
So okay, so oatmeal cookie is fine. Dressing his daughters up in fucking seashell bikini shit. But when someone else takes that seashell bikini off and all of a sudden has penetration going on, it's not okay for oatmeal cookie. All right.
That was back then.
His stuff was borderline porn anyway for like that era. Now he doesn't
give a damn.
So dumb. Yeah, I guess he doesn't. He really has no say or
shit.
Really any care in that. You've been oddly quiet. Are you deleting your Nintendo porn as we speak?
I have a lot of Tumblr accounts to log into.
Okay.
Oh, whoa, whoa there.
Heart, kitty cat, heart, meow, meow, kitty, heart, heart. Gotta get that one. Gotta get it down quick. Hurry. Our next story. Telltale game is gonna be Guardians of the Galaxy. Who wrote this story? Who put this on the docket?
I did.
Okay. Why was it duh for you?
Because of course they're going to.
Why? What's out of popular? All the Marvel things.
What's popular?
Spider-Man.
You know who has the license of Spider-Man?
Marvel.
Sony.
Yeah, you're right.
They're already making a Spider-Man game, so they're gonna do that.
Uh-huh.
What's coming out? Guardians of the Galaxy 2?
Yeah.
So what's Telltale do? They make games on popular stuff.
Oh.
Of course they're gonna do Guardians of the Galaxy.
I will be 100% honest. I think this one is gonna be good.
Aren't they all, apparently?
No. Some are better than others. I hear Tales of the Borderlands was really good.
I heard the only one I heard kind of mixed things about was the Game of Thrones.
Oh, I
heard
know.
That wasn't great. Obviously, their early stuff was real bad, like Jurassic Park. But
yeah. Like I'll say their best stuff so far that I've played has been season one of Walking Dead.
Mm-hmm. That's kind of when they blew up. Yeah, I'd say.
Dude, the first season of Walking Dead was probably their best.
Apparently, the Batman one's pretty good.
I heard that was not good. At least the latest episode of the Batman one was not good.
I don't know about that. I heard there was a good twist that changed the formula. I don't know how after that.
Interesting. Scoochie, why don't you play those? Like, at least the Batman one? You love Batman.
Just haven't had the time.
Ah.
I know they just introduced the Joker into it.
Yeah. But Guardians of the Galaxy, I'm down for that. Like, here's the thing. The great thing about a Marvel-made Telltale game, they could do anything they want. Anything. They could kill off main characters, everything. Because in Marvel, no one ever stays dead. Or they could just make it a non-canon spinoff.
You have to guess that they're going to make a Star Wars one, yeah?
For sure.
That's going to be an interesting one.
Probably come out for the episode, whatever the hell.
Whatever eight? The new one will be after Rogue One.
Yeah. It'll be like Guardians of the Galaxy than that, maybe.
I don't think they have the... I don't know if they have the game rights to fucking, like, the Fantastic Four characters, the Cosmics, like Galactus and Silver Surfer and shit, but that would be nice. But we'll see. I'm down for this, whatever this may be, so...
Apparently it's going to be revealed at the Game Awards next month.
Oh, that's actually a really good time to show that. Guardians of the Galaxy is probably one of the most niche mainstream comic franchises ever. So, good on you, Marvel Telltale.
That's December 1st. That's pretty
close. That's super close. Dude, that's 3 days from now. 2 days from now.
Is it?
Yeah. From the time of this recording, it's 2 days from now.
It might be a few more days before that. Yeah.
our next news story here. Hatsune Miku, Project Diva Future Tone, releases January 10th in America and Europe. there's a caveat to this.
There is. It says future in the name.
It's digital only.
What's
bullshit.
More futuristic than digital only?
It's so bullshit. I mean, there was no physical for it in Japan either, but at the same time, fuck.
This is the arcade game?
This is the big one that I talked about in another podcast that I mistakenly thought was going to be Project X.
Uh-huh.
This is the one I was talking about. The one that has 200 plus songs in it.
Yeah.
It's an unprecedented amount in a fucking rhythm game.
And 300 costumes.
There's a lot of shit in this game. I'm probably going to pick it up.
Of course you're going to pick it up.
I'm fucking mad that it's not physical, though.
Yeah,
I would have really liked this one to be physical. I don't like digital. I never like digital.
You love it.
No.
Yeah, but it comes out real soon.
Yeah, but no. All right. I'm super down, though. I still haven't beaten
X. It has the best song.
It has all the songs in it, dude. All of them. So many Pinky Promise.
Depends on which version you buy.
Well, the one I'm getting is going to have all of them, so...
It's, at least it's not, like, full 60. It's 54.
Yeah. I really would have just... Oh, physical would have done it for me, though. That would have been the announcement of the century.
Physical for the other one.
Yeah, but X wasn't... That wasn't the one I wanted.
Story
I thought it was...
mode.
Yeah. Bert,
did
Scoots.
You ever continue that?
Bert, yeah. Scoots, we must get the magical singing MacGuffins. Will you guys help me?
I mean, what kind of story were you expecting?
No, but at the same time, like, I'm still not convinced that a quartz is see-through or whatever. I forgot what that thing was. Oh, well. I'm down. Just not...
Or are you down to clown?
Not 100%, because it's not
300 costumes. 300.
That's a lot.
That's a lot of costumes.
That's a lot of idle
masters.
At least
you won't have to worry about load times.
Yeah,
but I was like, can I have a PS Pro patch?
Oh, low blow.
Oh, that reminds me of PS4 Pro. You know you can actually use solid states now. I mean, you could always use solid states, but like fully use the solid state drive now.
Now it'll load even faster.
You utilize its actual speed. Because it has SATA 3.
Pretty good.
So January 10th, I'll be doing Project Diva Future Tone. Stay tuned, everyone. Oh, and to answer your question, Bert, I never beat X.
Oh. You're going to play it until you unlock the song.
Which, Pinky Promise is an X?
It is. Well, no, the new one. I'm saying when you stream that.
Oh, yeah, of course. I'll play that one specifically for you.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe you actually like that song. That's such a demented, dark, twisted song. It's
like, I don't like any of the songs that are on there. I just read the lyrics as it goes by, and it's the best.
The first game had like it was just Japanese, so you couldn't understand. So I'm imagining half of those happy-go-lucky songs were about like
they have translations.
No, not in the first game. The second one had translations. The first one was all Japanese, even the lyrics that showed up on the bottom. But the second one had, like, translations.
That was my favorite part, because it was all just broken English.
Yeah, like that one song that you and Grizzly hated.
That song was really weird.
The ice one that took place in the snow. I didn't realize it was actually English, but, like, really, really weird sounding. She was speaking in English the entire time, not Japanese. I didn't know that.
Well, I mean, Vocaloids? Yeah.
Vocaloid, yeah.
That's Japanese Vocaloids making stuff in English.
It's like, not all of them sing in English. Some of them sing in Japanese, but like.
Well, yeah.
There are some songs that are really good. I actually kind of dig some of the songs in there. I agree. There's some songs that sound super weird. Like, you just tell it's fucking robotics. Like, it sounds
of them you can.
Well, yeah, but like, some actually have a good, like.
I'm not saying they're all bad. I'm just saying you can usually tell.
Yeah. But there's some bad ones where it's just like, it sounds like someone did like, what was that old thing? Fuck. It used to be really like all over the music back in like late 2000s.
Auto-tune?
Auto-tune, yeah. It's like someone went crazy with auto-tune in some songs. Some songs sound better than others, but yeah, I'm down for more Project Diva. And this might be the last one for a while, obviously. So I'm going to get it.
Yeah, people got to make more songs.
Got to make
more games.
More Pinky Promises.
I mean, I assume people are still making music for this stuff, yeah?
Of course. They will never stop.
That has to be a licensing nightmare, unless they just automatically claim everything that's made with the software.
Yeah, I don't know how it works.
I'm just assuming it's a nightmare.
It probably is. But they got this shit down for that release. Speaking of things not down for the release, our next news story, Persona 5 was delayed until April 4th.
Will contain that transition.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. It will contain free Japanese audio DLC, though.
Yep.
Hey, this is the dual audio that everybody wanted, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's nice that everyone gets it.
Yeah, it is nice.
It's delayed.
No, no, it's not. It's nice that it's free.
Bert has that fake smile going on.
Oh, you could totally see it on his face. He's got that throbbing vein on his forehead. It's like, I can't believe I have to wait an extra month.
2 months.
An extra 2 months.
Well, I mean, like a month and a half.
Especially from the date of this recording.
From the date of this recording, so way longer than that.
No, no, 2 months from now. We're literally recording this future and sending it back to the past. That's how far ahead we are. But yeah, dual audio, that's great. Especially if the voiceover cast can't do it for me.
I guess. I don't know. It's cool. I know
this is what everyone wanted in the first place.
Yeah, for sure. So, they should have always been giving it.
You think?
I don't see it. Well, I guess there's licensing, but
yeah,
that should be in the contract whenever they first do it anyway.
Either way. I don't mind waiting a little longer to get it. I will admit I was like, another delay, but I'm like, the game's gonna be good either way when it comes out, so who cares?
Just keep avoiding the net.
Just keep avoiding that internet until then. Damn, what a wait.
Yep.
Speaking of waiting, we no longer have to wait to find out what Japanese people love of SEGA of Japan's IPs. So, our next news story, last week, SEGA of Japan had a survey which asked which franchise fans wanted to see revived and such. So, Japanese people answered, and here were their answers.
I'm very sad that some of these aren't higher than they should be.
Yeah. So, most hoped for revival, obviously number one was going to be Sakura Wars.
I can get down with that.
Japan, that is Japan's favorite SEGA franchise. Sakura Wars, obviously. Number two would be Jet Set Radio. I also would like that.
Nah.
Scoots?
Yeah? What?
I was just asking.
Jet Set Radio?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That was number two. Number three, Virtual On. Yes.
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 Number four, Shenmue. Yeah. Nope. Yes.
They should keep that buried.
Yeah, Shenmue 3 is only coming.
I mean, yeah. Then they're going to have to crowdfund the fourth one.
Oh, fuck. Number five, Virtua Fighter. Yes? Please?
Yes.
Yeah. Definitely needs to be a new VF.
For sure. Number six, Panzer Dragoon.
Eh.
I want it, but at the same time, I want a Drakengard crossover with it. I really want it.
Yes, give Drakengard a frame rate that's actually playable.
that's working. Number seven, Shining Force. And I like that it's Shining Force because it's like, that tells them that's like, hey, the old ones, not the new ones.
Didn't EXA have Shining Force in the title? And the other one. So they could go to that. Is that what you guys want?
No.
Oh,
they
Bert.
Like their action games now.
Bert,
they're turning Valkyrie into an action game.
No.
Bert, I love how you're triggering him. This is good. This is good.
It's, you know that's going to happen if they do it.
No. I know you're right, but at the same time, no. God damn it. Coming in at number eight with Skies of Arcadia. You know, I'm fine with that being the way it was.
Did you just say Skies of Arcadia?
Yeah.
Hey, Bert, you still have that game case?
I do.
Can I now flip the table now?
Yeah, there we go. Number nine, Streets of Rage. Yes.
Yes.
Nah.
Of course.
And I'm glad this one.
And number 10, Nights Into Dreams. Yes.
It should never be made again.
As long as it's not done in the Wii style. I'm down. And we're just going to quickly go through the brands they were most invested in. Number one was Sakura Wars. Number two was Sonic. Number three, Phantasy Star Online. Number four, Virtua Fighter. Five, Jet Set Radio. Six, Yakuza. Seven, Panzer Dragoon. Number eight, the Sega Saturn. That's weird. Number 9, Persona.
That is weird.
And number 10, Project Diva. Well, you remember...
Wait, oh, I guess they can claim Persona now.
Yeah.
I was like, wait a second.
That is under their umbrella now. For those that are wondering what the Sega Saturn's doing there, you forget, in Japan, Sega Saturn was the most popular Sega system of all time.
But, like, brands, like...
That is a brand. They love the... Like, you know how, like, in certain regions of the world, Sega is popular in certain... Like, in America... People think of Genesis as the set go-to Sega system. Maybe Dreamcast. In, like, what's it called? Mexico and... Brazil and stuff like that. Sega Master mm-hmm. System was the most popular. In Japan, it was Sega Saturn. In Europe, it was the Mega Drive. You know, so, like...
It's just weird for it to be on this list with the... Like games.
That was the equivalent. It didn't beat PlayStation, but it was a close second in Japan. It beat N64.
I just realized. Yeah. If they make a new Sakura Wars,
mm-hmm.
it's just going to turn out to be garbage.
Why?
They're going to put Tony Talk on it. They're going to put the Shining people on the gameplay.
No, you mean the Wild Arms people?
Or whoever makes this garbage now. I mean, do they have any studios that can do any of this anymore?
The Valkyria Chronicles studio.
What are they doing?
Or they can make it all mobile.
To my knowledge, nothing right now.
Like I said, Justin. Yeah. Or they can make everything that you've ever loved mobile.
They've already done that.
Going crazy mobile mode? Or are they done?
Who?
Sega. Weren't they going with all kinds of crazy mobile stuff? They did that Sonic... game.
Yeah, they're not as crazy. Like, they don't do the thing that other Japanese studios are doing now with huge trailer announcements and stuff for mobile games and stuff like that. Like, they dialed mm-hmm. that back a lot. They've really been more arcadey focused lately. Like, I forgot to add a story to this docket, but I'll get into that a little later. But finally, favorite character in Japan from Sega. Sega Tasanshiro. This ties in with the Sega Saturn's popularity, of course.
Yeah.
Number 2, Kazuma Kiryu. Number 3, Ryo Hazuki. Oh, I guess I should say what they're from. Ryo from Shenmue. Number 4, Bayonetta from Bayonetta. Number 5, Knights from Knights. Dr. Eggman from Sonic is number 6. 7 is Temujin from Virtual On. Number 8 is Arlie from Puyo Puyo. Number 9, Alex Kidd from Alex Kidd. And number 10, Ulala from Space Channel 5.
I'm surprised I'm surprised that Daytona's not on here.
You talking about Hornet? The car?
No, like even the brands with...
I think that was more popular in America than it was in Japan.
Then why is this the new one in Japan?
Because Daytona is still an arcade franchise that people love over there, but not as big as fucking like...
I'm surprised like they did that and they just realized like, hey, this is what people actually want.
Yeah. It's funny, but though.
I guess that's Sega in general, huh?
Yeah, I mean, the people could be requesting this, but in Japan, all they saw was like, oh, they want a new Sonic game, obviously. We should make a Japanese Sonic for the Japanese people, much like how America has boom now. Yeah, yeah.
They like Eggman more than Sonic, huh?
Yeah, isn't that weird?
Does that make sense?
Isn't that strange? I just realized that. That is weird.
Yeah, he's not on that list at all.
Sonic's not...
The series is. But...
Yes, they don't like... Okay, Japan does not like Sonic as much as Americans and Europeans do. He never it's caught
on
over
two
on
there. Their brands, though. Oh, you're talking about character?
Yeah, the character himself. He's never caught on over there. Like, the most popular Japanese character, I'll give you guys one guess. If you can guess it, you'll get multiple ups. Just think about Japanese culture, and then think about... You'll get a free pass because you just don't know.
Are you talking about Sonic characters?
Yeah, most popular Sonic character in Japan.
I have no idea.
Yeah, you wouldn't know this character.
I don't know many Sonic characters besides the main, like, four.
What about you, Scoots? Got any guesses?
For what?
I mean, everyone loves Amy, right?
Oh, God.
No, that is not true. Okay. Can deconfirm that offer right there.
Mm-hmm.
Most popular Sonic character in Japan, Scoots?
Shadow.
Incorrect.
It's not?
Nope. Who'd you say, Bert?
It's got to be Big the Cat.
Oh, of course. Yeah. Yeah. You got it.
Big the Cat.
No.
Okay. Wait. SPO.
Nope.
Hmm.
Got to think about those Japanese mannerisms.
Just say it.
Cream the Rabbit.
I don't know who that is.
I just died.
That's that little bunny girl that's super polite and respectful and bows her head all the time. And
I just died on the inside.
Yep, she's super popular over there. But yeah.
I don't know. It's not on the favorite character list.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Eggman's probably more popular. I'm sorry.
Because he has the master plan.
He does. I'm hoping that Sega did this, A, to see which franchises need reviving, for sure. And B, if they plan on doing some sort of Sega crossover fighting game, that would be amazing. If they got some characters in there. Like, what's that one game we were supposed to play last year? Dengeki Fighting Woko Climax?
Yeah.
I hope they get those people just to make a Sega fighting game. Because at that point, it was already halfway there. The stages were all Sega. They had two Sega characters in there. Might as well go the full route and just make it a fucking Sega 2D sprite fighter.
Well, they had that Project Cross Zone where they put everything in.
Yeah, but that's not a fighting. That's a
an action crossover. No, I'm just saying they used all these kind of characters for that.
True. So, I'm not really surprised by the answers, all things considered.
I'm surprised Sakura's not on there for characters.
That is weird. That is very strange. Yeah, you're pointing out a lot of good things here that I failed to notice.
But to be fair, there's not very many votes if you count it all up.
Yeah. They just like the series. They don't actually like the characters in it.
I guess so.
Yeah.
This is like a small sample size is what I meant.
Super small. It's fine. You know what else is fine? But not really? Our next news story.
Mm-hmm.
EA says it's going to bring one of its shitty games to the Nintendo Switch.
You like EA.
I fucking hate EA. What have they done for me lately? Besides shit on everything I love.
You're just salty from the past.
Mm-mm. Even now, the hate still burns. EA sucks. But here's the quote that was used in the article. It says, in terms of Nintendo, in their announcement, they announced that we'll be supporting with a game or two on that new platform. We haven't yet announced what game, but you should assume it's one of our bigger games that we've been involved with. So obviously it's going to be a sports game.
Sports game.
Madden and...
Maybe Mass Effect if they want to try and...
Sure.
No.
Mass Effect should be coming out when this comes out.
Sure.
I don't think that's going to... No.
What would it be then? We know for sure it's a sports game.
They put Mass Effect 3 on the Wii U.
Yeah, but like... No. No.
What could it possibly be? It's the start of a new thing, so they don't need the old ones to be on there. It's going to be a sports game, or the only thing I can think of it would be Mass Effect. If they want to get out.
No.
What does EA make?
Sports?
Yeah, well, we know that already.
Mass Effect?
Uh-huh.
They publish Battlefield. They publish Titanfall. They publish...
Why are you saying publish?
Battlefield or Titanfall for Switch.
They're not going to do that.
They will. It's going to need a shooter. And it'll have the market cornered for
it's
it.
It's going to have Splatoon.
Baby games. People need real men shooters.
Whenever Call of Duty was launched with the Wii U, it did very, very poorly.
I wonder why. It couldn't have been because the Wii U itself was a poorly launched system, Bert. Not the fact that it was a Nintendo console. You remember a game called The Conduit on the Wii? Shooters do fine, they just need to be on a good selling system.
You know, speaking of shooters, you know what I found at GameStop? I just remembered this.
Go ahead.
The Duke Nukem Collection for PlayStation 4.
Good job.
You sound enthused.
I mean, every time I think of Duke Nukem now, I just think of that last game that came
Forever?
Out. Yep, that one.
I don't even think Forever's on that thing. It's just all it's the older ones.
The old ones.
Yeah.
Oh.
They're good ones.
They made new levels, I think.
But the box art and everything, it doesn't look right.
You'll have to pardon my unenthusiasm.
Hey, you like Doom.
I do love Doom. I retrospectively now love the whole series now because of that one game.
And you love all the clones that came out.
Nope. I want to get one of those little floaty eyeball demons.
The Keiko demons?
Yeah, I love those things. Those are my favorite. It's my favorite design thing in that game. I love how fucking creepy it looks. Sorry. Back to EA and its shitty, not Doom franchises. They're bringing one of their awful, awful games that you shouldn't buy on the Switch.
I mean, all companies are going to put something out on launch and then abandon it.
Yeah, but EA's going to do it harder. They're going to do it the fastest. No, they're going to abandon it so hard.
Ubisoft's going to do it the hardest.
It's true, just like they did with the Wii U. We're going to make this exclusive.
Every single game on there, then just get out.
No, we're not making it exclusive. We're actually not making it exclusive, and we're going to just fucking bail the fuck out.
When Ubisoft leaves a platform, you know it's done.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. 100%.
No ass Creed on that Wii U, that's for sure.
They can't even get it to run on the other systems.
Oh, boy. Yeah, that is true. What was the one with the fucking faceless people and shit? That really creepy looking one?
What was that one?
Unity?
It was the one in Paris or France or something. Yeah, I think that was it.
Yeah, Unity on a Wii U sounds amazing.
Jeez.
Speaking of amazing, the Game Awards 2016 nominees were announced in our next news story. You guys want to know what it was?
Are we going to go after all this?
I'll just cover the ones that are important. So, Game of the Year, obviously. Here are the nominees. Doom, which I think should win. Inside, which I hear is amazing. Overwatch, which I also think should win. Uncharted 4, Thief's End. Titanfall 2.
I don't think Titanfall 2 will win because not enough people played it.
Right. Uncharted 4, I don't think is going to...
Inside might win for like a hipster type vote.
Yeah.
It's a good game. I don't mean anything bad about it.
No. I think Overwatch is going to take this, no problem. Easy. Yeah,
I don't know how they do votes, or if it's like judges, or if it's a...
Me neither.
I think it might be judges. If it's judges, I think Overwatch or Doom will win.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be between Overwatch.
If it was like in all the public voting, it would be definitely Overwatch.
Yeah, for sure. I'm going to assume it's going to be Overwatch or Doom. Strongly leaning towards Overwatch.
Like, I'm No Man's Sky isn't on there.
I wonder, huh? Speaking of, let's move on to the... We're going to skip the best studio, best narrative, best art direction, best music. Actually, no, we're going to go over this one real quick because there's something in here I want to talk about. Best Music Sound Design. Battlefield 1 is a nominee. Doom is a nominee, which I also think it should get second place. Inside is on there. And Res Infinite, the fucking amazing game it is on here.
I don't think Res should be counted since it's such an old game.
But what about Area X, which I have not seen? Don't anybody talk to me about it, but I hear it's amazing.
I'll tell you about it.
No, I hear it's an experience.
I think Thumper could win.
Thumper is pretty good. I heard that's really good.
But it'll probably be Doom.
Doom, it was amazing with the soundtrack.
I can't think of any music from Battlefield, so okay.
And I can't stop thinking of Fear is the Mind Killer from Rez, so we're at a standstill. What is it, Bert?
It's like a cheating vote.
No, it's not. It's a fucking rhythm game that came out on VR with updated graphics.
Yeah, but it's a re-release with one new area.
But the music is so good, it deserves to be judged. It never got the Game of the Year it deserved.
It should have got Game of the Year the game it came out.
Well, they didn't have those back then.
Well, they should have not made their game until now.
Oh, well. Okay, that's your opinion. That's okay. It's okay. Our next... not next new story. Hang on. Let's go down. Games for Impact Award. Best Independent Game. Best Mobile Handheld Game.
No, Best Independent Game. I hella want Stardew Valley to win.
Oh, you do? Okay, Best Independent Game nominees are Firewatch, Hyper Light Drifter, Inside, Stardew Valley, and The Witness. Not Inside Stardew Valley. It's called Inside, and then the next game is called Stardew Valley.
Stardew Valley's so good. And it's made by one dude.
I just saw Stardew Valley, and I just thought about you, Bert.
Me too.
Oh, you played it too?
No, I'm thinking about him playing Stardew Valley.
I have a chicken named Tintin.
Of course.
The best VR game nominees are Batman.
It might be a duck.
Oh my god. Get out, Bert. Just get out.
Bert, I realized something. I realize now what you should be doing in games. You're supposed to be a breeder. That's your thing.
Maybe.
You need to play Harvest Moon. The old ones, not the new ones.
I should.
Play Back to Nature. You will never stop.
You skipped over best mobile handheld.
Yeah.
What?
There's what? A Monster Hunter.
Huh?
Monster Hunter Generations.
Oh, I'm sorry. When it said mobile, my eyes glazed over and I skipped over it.
They put mobile and handheld together.
Yeah, but you know Pokemon it's Go.
It's going to be Pokemon Go.
Yeah, best no mobile handheld game. Obviously, the nominees are Clash Royale. I've never heard of that.
That Quad Lariat. Really? Fire Never. Face and Monster Hunter Generations.
Is Clash Royale one of those stupid, like, ones with the stupid commercials with the guy sitting at the table at a restaurant and all of a sudden their phone turns into a battlefield and it's like, oh no, yeah. They shoot the paintball! You could be a war vet at Battle of Titans, Clash Royale, Gummy Bear, Candy
lines.
Crush Saga, fucking ass.
I remember there was a commercial with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
That one.
And a chopper, yeah.
Fucking stupid. All these fucking mobile games are all the
same. They make so much money.
I know, but they're all the same. Did you see the one article of a picture of the icons for all of them? They're like all generic army dudes with like the helmet on and stuff like that.
They're screaming.
Yeah, screaming. It was really good. I'm like, they all are the same. Never heard of Clash Royale, but Fire Emblem Fates.
It's super popular. Like, holy crap.
Probably to you, maybe. And then Monster Hunter Generations, then Pokemon Go, then Sever. Yeah, that's no contest, obviously.
Like the two that we would play and like want to have win are nowhere close.
Nope, Fire Emblem Fates and Monster Hunter Generations stands no chance.
Yeah, they're non-starters.
Yep. Pokemon Go is going to take it so hard that we might as well not have even read it.
Yeah.
Best VR game, Rise Infinite is the only nominee. The one that matters. Best action game, who cares? Doom is in there.
This almost the same as Game of the Year.
Yeah. Best action adventure game. Nope. Best role playing game. I'll go over this one because I hate RPGs so much I need to read these.
Surprised they put Chronicles X on there.
Yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles X is a nominee. World of Warcraft Legion, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, Deus Ex, Mankind Divided.
They put DLC on here.
Oh, Wild Hunt, Blood and Wine, and Dark Souls 3.
Witcher 3 was last year.
I know, but I don't know why they put the DLC.
Because it's that damn good.
Because the game's so good, they're like, yeah, let's we'll put that on there again.
Put that
it's a whole new game. It's a whole new game.
I mean,
it kind of is, but no.
Or we could just go with, you know, Dark Souls 3 because best game ever.
It's pretty good.
It's a good game, but I don't think it's going to win. It might.
It's
that
compared to that are Deuce Ex.
Nah, Deuce Ex not going to do it.
Really? Nah. That game got the hype fucked out of it. I mean, the fuck hyped out of it.
It'll be Dark Souls 3, Witcher, and maybe Legion.
Okay. Best fighting game. Our nominees are Killer Instinct Season 3, King of Fighters 14, Pokken Tournament, and Street Fighter 5.
I want you to note, this is the only one with 4 nominees. Everything
that is weird,
has at least 5. And there's a controversy.
Uh-oh.
People wanted to get, I can't even remember the name, it's that Heron's Duel game? The one with the cat lady that fights stuff?
I've never even heard of what you're talking
Apparently
about.
Apparently a bunch of the judges voted for that and they refused to put it on.
Because it's indie?
I don't know. It's a conspiracy.
Bert's really enthusiastic about that. I like this.
Every time when I hear Bert...
It's Nitro Blasters. That's what the name was.
Oh, I heard about that.
Every time I hear you say conspiracy, I just can picture you just sitting there...
Rubbing his
hands
together.
...in your chair, rubbing your hands together, licking your freaking lips, just like... Ugh.
Bert fucking loves conspiracy dramas.
Do I?
You do.
I don't think any of these should win.
No? Damn. Oh, no. What do you think should win?
I'm going to say Killer Instinct Season 3.
I did have a lot of fun with Killer Instinct.
Yeah, but like... I don't know. These games kind of fell off. Except for, I guess, Street Fighter. That just fell off on the mainstream and not the pro scene.
Yeah. Yeah. Slim pickings this year. Out of all the four games, I've played 3 of them. I would say I had the most fun with Killer Instinct so far.
That's right, you never did play Pokken. I just remembered that.
Nope. Bert told me not to.
I didn't tell you not to.
You told me not to. I have the text message to prove it on my fucking tweet phone.
I told you not to buy it without playing it first.
Mm-mm.
You asked me, you're at the store, and you're like, should I buy it?
That's the exact same thing as saying, don't play it. Okay. Either way, You know what should be on this list?
Hmm.
Virtual Fighter 5 Final Showdown.
You know what should be on this list?
What's that?
Tekken 7.
That Shining fighting game.
Oh, that did come out this year.
Guess what? It's right here, right here. Steam right here. I can just, like, gift it.
Nope. You do that, you're wasting your money, my friend. I refuse to play it.
That doesn't matter. As long as
you did so well, though.
Nope.
You did. You beat me with Rick.
You picked Ryu and killed us.
That's what happens. That's what happens.
How does it feel to play a show, though?
Eh. I feel no guilt in the shitty Shining fighting game, so... Best family game, who cares? Best strategy game, let's go into this one. Nominees are Civilization VI, Fire Emblem Fates, The Banner Saga 2, Total War Warhammer, XCOM 2. I see XCOM 2 taking this. Civ. Maybe Civ.
Yes, Bert, I know. Civ will take it. I know, Bert. My freaking GTX 1080 can handle Civ. I know.
Can handle everything on this list.
I know, yes.
Next category, best sports racing game, who gives a shit? Best multiplayer game. Eh.
I'm surprised Overcooked's on there. That's pretty funny.
That's really good, I guess.
Oh, don't forget about best fan creation. There's your other... That doesn't exist anymore.
Oh, you mean the stuff that got pulled?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. And most anticipated game. You could choose from God of War, Horizon Zero Dawn, Mass Effect Andromeda, Red Dead Redemption 2, and Legend of Zelda, Shit of the Wild.
You're so... enthusiastic about Zelda games.
I am.
Don't draw Tumblr porn.
Oh, God. I must, I got some things to do too, I guess. I'll be right back. Stall for time.
No.
Good job, boys. You stall for time. I think God of War is going to take the most anticipated game.
Yeah, I don't know. It's going to be Red Dead.
All right, yeah, I forgot Red Dead.
Speaking of Red Dead, that's what I just got Black Friday. It's right here. Great. Game of the Year edition.
Now you'll be ready to play the second one when it comes out next
year.
And
the case is different, too, compared to, you know, all the other 360 game cases.
Yeah, they have the new case where it shows, like, both of them, right? Xbox One and 360?
On the side it says Xbox One, and then on the front it says Xbox 360.
Funky.
It's really funny. I looked at it, I'm like, this is weird.
But those are your Game Award nominees for the year 2016. Who will win? Tune in to that show and find out, and then tune into this podcast the week after, where we bitch and whine about the ones that didn't get win that we thought should win.
I'm not going to bitch and whine.
I will.
Yeah. I know you will.
Yeah. I'm already ready for it.
You are so into EA, it's like, you want to embrace it.
I can't believe EA didn't win Game of the Year for every category.
You at the moment are humping an EA pillow.
You don't even know. I'm sitting on one right now.
And then next to it is,
a picture of Mass Effect.
Yes, even though Mass Effect's really good, so shut up.
Yeah, for you, maybe. Next news story, 8 minutes of Daytona 3 was shown. Looks like. Okay, so you're probably wondering why I stopped reading the news story mid-read. We're reading the stories from the docket. Bert fucking altered my text.
I did nothing of the sort.
He did. My original story was 8 minutes of Daytona 3 was shown. Looks arcade as fuck. And he changed the text to be 8 minutes of Daytona 3 shown. Looks archaic as fuck. Good job, Bert. You almost got me to read that, too.
I did.
You almost fooled me, idiot.
But I like the camera.
It takes
a picture of the person playing it.
Yeah, I like that it looks like it's using the exact same engine as the first two games. Very, 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 very old arcade style.
Mm-hmm.
And Bert doesn't like it because he hates arcades.
I didn't say that.
You put archaic, which I assume is a bad word.
Archaic is old.
Oh.
Like an archive?
Yeah, sure. For you, maybe. This game looks great.
The one thing I think I would be annoyed about with that is...
The graphics?
They have that same... No, I meant the, like, setup they have.
Oh.
Or they're all next to each other playing the same song at different intervals.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
This video is amazing.
So many like cabinets next to each other. It's all playing the same song at different times. So it's just,
it's weird because I'm thinking I used to play those side by side machines. And I thought that all the music was synced up properly. They usually always synced up because all the races start at the same time when you start with the rolling start. I could be wrong though. I could have sworn they were all synced up.
Something awesome.
No, Bert, what you might have been seeing is like people playing two separate races.
Well, yeah, that's what I meant.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say,
like, if they're all playing on the same, maybe.
Yeah, if you all slide like your card, your Dave and Buster's card at the same time, you all get in the same race, so it's all synced up. But if you don't, then people are playing different races with different people.
Yeah, if you watch that video that you was part of, it's music going at different intervals.
Yeah, that one dude was playing on the second race or whatever really sucked, and the other guy was doing all right.
All I saw was that guy was hitting other cars, and he did a complete 360, and he ran into other people. I'm like, that sounds amazing.
I like that they
used it. This reminded me when I played it with you.
Yeah.
And I did that, and I got first place out of the whole thing.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fine.
And then you were like, you scumbag!
He scumbagged me. Don't worry. My vengeance is still coming. It's building up.
This is not how you play karaoke racing RPGs.
Exactly. How could you do that to me? We were supposed to be having a fucking karaoke session. He fucking rams me into the wall and then takes first place. That's not how this works. Daytona is like a super, super fun arcade racer game. And I hope eventually, years from now, 10 years from now, we'll get a port on Xbox Arcade or PSN, whatever.
It looks like it's from 10 years ago.
It does, doesn't it? Hey, Bert, Sega doesn't pride itself on its...
They used to. That's what Daytona 1 was.
Yes, but that was way back when Sega was like, we are the arcade people.
Nothing could live up to that thing for so long.
Even now, graphics still have not achieved the graphical output that the Daytona machine has. Machines wish they could do fucking 126-bit, 60 frames a second Daytona USA.
Now arcades are behind everything.
Yeah,
Sad. I guess there's not enough money to be put into that.
That is weird to think that arcades were once more powerful than consoles. They were basically computers. Computer boards. Yeah.
Like, if you look at Tekken 7, I believe it runs on, like, a Windows 10 machine.
Oh, well, yeah, that makes sense then.
Or something like that.
Yeah, I'm loving the remastered songs they've done so far. So...
Oh, do they have, like, clean songs?
Or is it all just from video? If you listen close, the audio that they're playing on that one...
Well, the audio's so messed up.
Yeah, well, I could tell one of the songs was definitely like a new. It was a re-record, like a remaster. The song sounds cleaner now, and it's definitely newly recorded like audio. So,
yeah, they're saying that the old Daytona guy was making new music for it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The old singer that did the Rolling Start song and Blue Skies, that guy.
What did those buttons on the side of the steering wheel? Do you remember?
Let me check real quick, because...
There was like 5 color buttons on the left side of it. And then there's a giant start button.
Let me see. If I remember correctly, that changes your view. Yeah, those change your view.
I need 5 buttons to change my view.
Or if you do manual transmission and fucking shift that stick to get that sick-ass drift.
Well, then usually there would be a stick on the side.
Yeah. Automatic transmission or manual? You choose. Speaking of choosing.
You always go manual.
You always go manual if you want the fastest car.
Yeah.
But rumor. Nintendo Switch to get Pokemon Stars, the third version of Pokemon Sun and Moon.
That's a dumb name. I'd rather That's have a Eclipse. Code name. I know.
It'll be like
probably gonna be Eclipse.
Yeah, exactly. Pokemon Eclipse. There you go. That's good. That's the way to combine them both.
Probably what it will be.
That's actually not a bad name. But yeah, that's pretty much the rumor. That's all needs to be said. We've already talked ourselves to death about Pokemon Sun and Moon. And if they decide to... I've been out of the Pokemon game for a long time. Scoots, for people like me who are stupid and not into Pokemon, what is the usual third version of Pokemon?
Usually it's a combination of both games. Most of the time.
What's new for them?
Do they get new stuff? Like, they I'm usually thinking get, of Yellow, which was obviously completely different in some aspects.
Oh, yeah.
They usually get different things. And sometimes the story changes depending on the version. Like, Platinum, it was radically different. I mean, like, it was the same, like, story-wise, but, like, they incorporated a whole, like, the Distortion World stuff and Giratina. And they added, like, another, like, bad guy and a whole bunch of other things to it. So, just imagine that, but they add more story to the game, and that would be the third version.
So, if this is true, and then Pokemon, a third edition of Pokemon is coming out on the Switch. Switch is gonna do it's gonna be doing really good. Fucking console handheld Pokemon game, finally.
Yeah, and to clarify, it's not rumored to be at launch or anything. It'll be later.
Yeah.
So don't get your Pokemon boners going just yet. Give it time to warm up.
Obviously, they wouldn't want to release it too close to this one.
No, that would piss people off.
Probably be like a year. Like, isn't that kind of what they do? Like a year after they do a third
version? It's usually yearly, yeah.
So maybe end of 2017, like holiday season, they could.
Same time next year?
Mm-hmm. For the Switch, and that would probably help their holiday sales.
Oh, yeah. For sure. But again, that is if this rumor is indeed true. So no need to bust a tumor. Right. It's nothing but a rumor.
And there's like screenshots of newer HD models and stuff like that.
Dude, I'm not gonna lie. Some of the stuff in Pokemon Sun and Moon looks awful. The map, for example, looks terrible. It's like not a good JPEG image or whatever it is. Like,
I like how you can zoom in on it and then it gets all super pixely.
It's super pixely. I'm like, this looks terrible.
Why does it look good? It looks even worse. It looks even worse on yours because you have a bigger screen.
Oh.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
The original resolutions is a screen that's like almost half the size.
It blurs the crap out of everything.
Okay, that would explain why. I'm like, why does it look so shit? It's made for this thing.
Sometimes the text in this game blurs.
I've noticed it on the side sometime.
Yeah.
That confuses the shit on me. I'm like, how is this happening? This is not like this is ported or anything. This is made for the system.
You should see it. I guess I didn't talk about this, but on the original 3DS,
yeah,
the frame rate is awful in some places.
What?
It's so bad. Like, if you get more than two Pokemon on screen,
how it is on this.
It tanks.
Oh yeah, I do notice frame rate drops when you have like more than two Pokemon.
And then the 4-player battle royale, it's like under 10 frames.
Wow,
it's real slow. But obviously, it's a turn-based game, so it's not that bad. But like, it looks awful.
It sounds awful. You are playing on the original 3DS, right?
Yeah.
Not for long, though.
Yeah, I was gonna say not for long.
Everywhere else it runs.
Black Friday deal right here.
I was super surprised to see how well it ran everywhere else. I was like, man, I expected this to just chug.
That's amazing.
Yeah, you know, throw more than two Pokemon in, it struggles.
Yeah, it's great having a new 3DS XL.
No, maybe I'll know soon.
Maybe I'll know sooner than later.
If that transfer stuff isn't as archaic as it looks like Daytona.
Oh, nice to bring it back to Daytona. Bert, you love Daytona. Don't fucking lie.
That's what I do.
Okay. Yeah, that is true. You are a liar. You're natural born. Our next news story.
Talk about some EA again.
Yeah, let's go ahead and talk about how shitty EA is. They require YouTubers and streamers to put labels on their sponsored videos.
This is actually the best thing any company has done.
Why? Do tell, Bert. Tell me and Scoots why this is a good thing, you fucking EA apologist.
Well, this is part of the law now.
Mm-hmm.
And it shows that, hey, you can't, like, what's the word I'm looking for?
Okay.
I don't know what word I'm looking for.
You can't put out our video without putting some form of thing saying that we made the game.
Yeah, you can't, well, no, not like that. They can't mislead people. Like, hey, I love this game. They have to, like, if they're sponsored and paid for that kind of content, they have to disclose it.
Uh-huh.
Which is now the law.
Uh-huh. I miss back to the shady times when you could get away with fucking making websites about gambling and then making a video on the said website about gambling and then not get caught. Thanks, EA. You're ruining everything.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah. How am I supposed to fucking push my fucking Nintendo porn gambling website? I can't do it anymore because now I have to disclose it, and then Nintendo's gonna find me and then give me a DMCA.
No, you don't only have to disclose it if Nintendo's paying you to do it.
And which they would until they decide to take me down for good publicity. See, I'm the scapegoat on this.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, they'll make an example out of me. I'm sure by mentioning Nintendo porn on this podcast, we're probably gonna get this thing taken down.
Yeah,
this
just
podcast.
Don't publish it to your Tumblr. You'll be good.
That's fine. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Good thinking, Bert. Quick on your feet.
And careful with the thumbnail. Don't want to get your account closed again.
That, I can't promise you anything on that. I can't promise you anything on that.
Mm.
Might be a raunchy-ass thumbnail. I'm just going to let you know that.
I'm sure you'll do that.
You know I'm good at that. Atelier Firis. I don't even... How do you say this?
Atelier?
Atelier Fire. For PS4 Vita is coming to the West in spring 2017, and the PC version was also announced.
What the only reason I put that on there is because it's on PC.
I thought you were about to say the whole reason you put that on was to see me struggle trying to say the name.
That too.
Good job. You did
okay,
it.
Let me ask you, Bert, how do you say the second name?
Yeah, how do you say that?
Is it Firis?
I would say Firis, but I don't know. I haven't heard it in English.
Firis? Firis?
It could be Firis. It could be Firis.
Atelier Firis.
The one bad thing is it's a game published by Koei Tecmo.
No, that's
their
good.
PC well, port, their PC well, ports have been awful.
No,
that sounds right. I mean, they played DOA. It seemed all right now.
And Atelier Firis is extremely busted in Japan right now. So,
yeah.
They're like,
so why did you add this news story then?
I'm interested in it if they can fix it. Atelier games are pretty good.
Are they?
Some of them.
All right, then.
And I just think it's interesting that they're putting it on PC now.
I'm glad you think that, Bert.
But
I
can
love
can
that.
But can it top the awesomeness that is the bread baker's simulator?
Shining?
Nothing
can be Shining.
Okay.
I'm not laughing anymore.
Imagine if they put those on PC.
Oh.
Pretty stoked.
No.
Bert would have a marathon.
No. Speaking of things that make me depressed.
Better yet, Bert would play the game, and then there would be a cam for Justin, reaction cam.
It's me fucking getting a noose ready in my room as he's playing it.
Just goes through phases, just like, ugh!
And then he'll
be like, oh, I like that character.
Toaster in the bathtub. Alright. Speaking of things that make me want to drop a toaster in a bathtub. Looks like the upcoming Monster Hunter movie will be joining its game brother in Shit Town.
I don't know. Sounds pretty cool.
Okay, so for those of you wondering, but you guys love Monster Hunter. How could you say the movie sounds bad? Here's why. Resident Evil's director, producer person, W.S. Anderson, guy behind Alien vs. Predator, which I admittedly have a guilty pleasure with, Death Race, and the still ongoing but nearly finished Resident Evil series, is going to be working and producing on this. So, here is the movie's logline. Here we go. For every monster, there is a hero. An ordinary man in a dead-end job discovers that he is actually the descendant of an ancient hero. He must travel to a mystical world to train and become a monster hunter before the mythical creatures from the world destroys ours.
What?
Yep.
What?
Yep. It's your generic, typical Hollywood taking cool game idea story and shitting all over it. Why? They could have just done it in the monster world, monster hunting world. Hunter guy has to hunt monsters for family because family is starving. I don't know, something simple. Why? This will be joining Warcraft in just the shitty movie bin.
Thanks. It's gonna do well in China.
Yeah, it'll do great in China. Not so much here. I just can't believe they're doing the ordinary man discovering super thing again. How many times, Hollywood, do you have to tell this story? Fuck. I don't know what I was expecting, but at least not this.
I said they'll have about the budget as the Resident Evil stuff.
Maybe. Hopefully it'll be a giant laser gate that fucking makes a guy cheddar cheese.
Ah. Cool, you'll get Rathaloses flying around.
The only reason I want to see is just to see the monsters, but I know it's just going to be that, oh, it's going to be that awful. Like, half the movie's going to be good, the other half is going to be shit. The part where they're in Monster Hunter World is going to be fine, but then, like, the real world shit is like, no.
We're still talking about this? Jesus.
No. I want Monster Hunter to be good. God damn it, I take movies very seriously.
No. Let's phase this out right now.
What else do you want to be good, Justin?
I want The Walking Dead Season 3 Episode 1 to be good, which comes out December 20th. That's our next news story. Yeah.
That's pretty soon.
Yeah. That's 22 days away from the date of this recording.
I think it's going to be the canon ending.
Yeah.
Which one do you think is going to be canon?
According to this, they're saying it's going to star two characters. It's going to be starring Clem and another new guy. It'd be like a Switch focus sort of deal with the story. So we're not sure? I don't know. I will not remember that because I don't know.
You gotta play it, yeah?
No.
Really?
Nope. Season 2 burned me out. I told you I'm done with everything Walking Dead now.
So he says.
Yeah, he's gonna watch it, see what
Scott
happens.
Scott will remember that.
I might watch it.
Like, are you interested in it?
No. No.
Then why did you put it on here?
I thought people would like to know.
All right.
I don't know. I'm not enthused like I was when I wrote down the story.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, then Walking Dead happened and I got really depressed. Speaking of depressing news, we're still on this This has been like a long series of depressing news stories in gaming lately. Reports show that Twitch chat is different when females are streaming.
No shit.
This just in. Water is wet. Fire is hot. Sky is blue. I think that's all it needs to be. We don't need to elaborate on this. Like, anybody who's ever been into a female streamer's Twitch, unlike me, because every time I go to someone who's streaming, they immediately end the stream, so I would never know.
Do you remember that bag of trash I told you I hit? It wasn't even like a forceful hit. It was just like I ran it over and it got stuck on the bottom of my vehicle.
Yeah. Was that some of the people who are commenting on the female streamers' stuff?
Basically, anyone who comments usually on female streams usually have trashy comments.
Oh, I thought you were going to say they're trash. So you were basically hitting them.
I mean, might as well.
I'm really confused on where this is going.
That's what the ban hammer's for.
Bert, have you not been paying attention? He said, oh, whatever.
I am saying the people on Twitch chat are trash.
That's what I was going
to say. And the ban hammer is me with the car hitting them.
I've only ever used trash on. Trash, jeez. Yeah. I only used chat on one stream, and that's the Bob Ross stream.
Oh, every other stream, I just remembered something I did this week, too.
Every other stream, I turn off chat.
There are some good streams with, you know, they actually have a decent chat.
No, there is not.
There has been one.
Name one.
Maybe not a popular streamer.
That's the thing.
It's just like, even my streams sometimes get shitty with comments. Sometimes. Sometimes there's one person.
Because you like Sonic.
That's no excuse. No excuse.
I'm gonna get grilled for that.
The Sonic fans are coming for your ass now. You done did it. Shook the bee's nest.
Joke's on them. I actually do like Sonic.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, we know. You've told us before.
If anybody needs to get fucking like, let's just reamed through the ass, it should be Bert.
I love Spinball, though. No. It's so good.
Who gives two shits about Spinball?
You know what? He needs two Lucilles. Both areas. It's reamed.
Just disgusting. So yeah, if you guys are into female streamers, which why wouldn't you be? Why would you not be? Why would you? If you're into streaming,
where are you going with this?
I don't know. I was. I, I'm having a bit of a crisis here.
Other news.
Thanks for the save.
More depression.
Oh God, I still haven't. Okay, the first news story of other news. The Ghost in the Shell trailer came out, and I still haven't watched it.
It is not bad.
Is it?
This is very anecdotal, but I've heard the movie's not terrible.
The trailer is not bad.
What? Even Bert said that, and he hates movies.
I haven't seen the trailer.
Would you please do me a favor and watch it for me and validate what Scoot said? It's okay, because if I watch this,
like when I first watched it, I was kind of like, I don't know how I feel about this. And then after a while, I watched it again.
This has a lot of views.
Too bad.
I was not expecting a Ghost in the Shell thing to have that much view.
It's a very popular series, Bert. One of my favorite animes of all time, and I can't handle if the movie's not done well. Tell me if the trailer looks promising.
What in the world was that?
Go watch the damn trailer.
I'm scared.
There's some bad CG in one of the parts.
Stop being spoopy and do the damn thing and watch it.
Oh,
be a man.
Oh, I'm
watching that man card.
I'm doing it. Of course, I have the audio off because I can't have it during while we're.
Now I'm gonna walk away.
Huh?
Those geisha ladies had weird CG.
Could be better. I can't unsee ScarJo's face. I can't not see it.
I like the overall aesthetic that they went for.
Yeah.
Like, the world looks cool.
It does. God, it's... Ah, ScarJo! No! It's not bad, but... This actually kind of looks accurate.
So, did you finish the trailer?
Halfway through. Was that Bato?
Yeah. Yep.
Whoa, he looks fucking weird.
You don't say.
Well,
seems interesting.
This does not look bad at all, actually.
Well, there you go. You have a new movie to go see.
I guess I do. Okay. All right, I remain cautiously optimistic.
That's how now you're where I'm at.
Yeah, good. We're at the cautiously optimistic yellow light right now. No green, just yellow. Anticipating any further news on this. That didn't look bad. I just ScarJo's face still throwing me off there, but it's fine. Makoto looks fine. Vato looked a little bit off, strange. But he's fine.
Well, I mean, he looks strange in the anime, too.
He does. Yeah, he really does. I keep forgetting.
Looks weird.
I guess I'm just used to seeing him like that. Like,
well,
that
yeah.
Weird. So, seeing him, like, their interpretation of him, like, in a CG, 3D, real life kind of thing, just looks off. So, yeah. Okay, I'm down. Cautiously. Next news story. I feel validated. I had to add this. Because this is something we never talked about on the podcast. Remember that time I had that accident and totaled my car last year?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Guess what? Texas and Louisiana have the worst drivers.
Woo!
Yeah.
That's why you went down there, yeah?
We're number one. That dude is dead. Yes, that's exactly what we got here.
That's like, oh, I just remember. There was an accident I've seen.
Oh.
You may have destroyed something and someone,
yeah.
But I've seen the ultimate business. It was whenever I went to the city last week. I think it was, last week. A guy on a motorcycle got obliterated by
a truck.
Was
he wearing his helmet?
Who the fuck knows? I know I saw a separated arm.
You know...
That's the ultimate business.
I feel...
There's just a giant red skid all over the road, and ultimate business.
I feel this goes without saying, but the safety of motorcycles? I don't know. I guess it's just a paranoia in me, but I'd rather be in a two-ton vehicle than a fucking motorized bike.
If you ride a motorcycle, you better
be careful.
Be cautious and always check your surroundings for everything and not be, well, I'm just gonna drive a motorcycle.
Okay, yeah. Don't be that a-hole that fucking weaves in between traffic and shit.
Yeah. I've seen those people.
I hate that. Bert has nothing to say because he doesn't drive.
I used to have a motorcycle when I was little.
I crashed it. Yeah, you used to drive that little motorcycle everywhere.
I crashed it. It was pretty
cool. So you fucking skidded on the road.
I mean, yeah.
Got that road rash.
It's dirt, but yeah.
Uh-huh, yeah. Poor Bert. So if you live in Texas and Louisiana like I do, be careful out there.
The hell is a grasshopper here?
You all right there?
No, it was just...
Would you like a moment to deal with that grasshopper?
I already took care of it. Don't worry about it.
Put it back in its cage?
Pet grasshopper. It's time for my favorite part of the podcast, the Q&A session. If you guys have any questions you would like to ask us individually or as a group, you can leave them below in the comments section, or you can send them to mondaynightwolfcast@gmail.com. Hey guys, what was that again?
I don't know what you're saying.
mondaynightwolfcast@gmail.com. Oh yeah. And your questions will be read on the podcast, the next one. So, our first and second question of the night comes from who else but our boy, Jen the Wolf, 18 times in a row. This man is like,
he's our new record.
Yeah, this man is like the number one. Thank you for your consistent questions every other week. It means a lot to us, especially Bert. He really enjoys it when you do two questions. Like, you don't understand.
He's a greedy person. I'm just letting you know that.
He's a fucking greedy person, and you don't have to indulge him. But we appreciate you doing that anyway. So, Jen the Wolf wrote, DC movies are hit or miss for me, but the Wonder Woman movie has potential. He's put in parentheses, please be a good movie. Question number one. Do you guys have any motivational things to say to an artist or anyone when they're feeling down about their work?
Never give up.
I believe Bert sent me a message the once. And it kind of stuck with me. Yeah, a YouTube video.
Oh.
Wait, a YouTube?
Do it! That one. That dank meme now.
Oh. Yeah, it quickly turned into a meme.
A dank meme.
Wow.
Yeah. That being said, my motivational thing to say to any artist or anyone feeling down about their work, Bert, you should actually have the most to say about this. You're very inspirational. You inspired me that one time.
I know. You are very good at that.
I liked you a video.
Yeah. That's all I did. Yeah. So say something very deep and poetic to the people.
Deep and poetic, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm not the best to ask because I'm the one who quit doing that kind of stuff.
Well, I mean, you have the most experience, so when they're feeling down, what do you say to yourself?
Just stop doing it.
Yeah, that's what they want to hear. Okay, so if you're feeling down and you feel like you're quitting...
I mean, the main thing to do is look at your old stuff and then look at your newer stuff and just see... I mean, you can easily see the progression.
If you can't, then you need to stop.
And if you can't, then you should look at it and see what is it that you don't like about it. Like, what can you change to make it better?
Yeah.
When it comes to actually being down about work in general, sometimes you need to take a small break away from whatever you're doing. Sometimes focusing on something too long will make you kind of feel not so into it. For example, anytime I'm doing something where I feel like I don't really want to do it, when I've lost my enthusiasm to do it, I'll usually put it down for a bit, do something else, refresh myself, then come back to it. Sometimes you never return to it, sometimes you do. You just feel it. You know how you feel about doing certain things. Overall, I'd say truly, truly never give up on what you love doing. Something I'd like to bring up is like people being negative about the things you do. Do not ever, 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 ever let anything negative said about you or your work affect how you do things. Never ever try to please people. Do what makes you happy, because you can't make everyone happy.
I was gonna say, do everything at your normal pace. Don't push yourself too hard.
Yeah, that too. Unless you have a deadline, of course, like you're running commissions and shit, but like...
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, then push yourself to get that deadline, but all I'm saying is, like, as far as, like, negative feedback, never, ever put too much thought into the negative feedback. Look into criticisms, constructive criticisms, sure, but, like, if someone says, like, this thing sucks and they didn't really offer any criticism, sometimes it, you know, it hurts to see those comments whenever you've worked really hard on something, but... Don't let it get to you. Think about all the positive comments you get, because you get like 50 positive comments and then one really bad comment that just kind of downs you. Don't look too hard into that.
Yeah.
And never show Justin your work.
Oh. Damn.
Oh, okay. This is about the cookie crisp, isn't it?
I sit here and I'm learning how to make a game. Every time I show him a new build, he tells me everything that's wrong with it and nothing about what's good about it.
I told you the game is fine. I told you the game was fun.
He never got another build after that.
Oh my god.
He's stuck on like build 6.
Oh my god.
You know what? You know what, Justin? Guess what I got?
What's that?
Go ahead, Bert. Tell.
What? The high score?
Yes, besides the high score.
what do you have?
The future build.
Oh.
Yes. He has the complete version.
Oh, is that how it is? Version. Yeah. Is that how it is?
It has the boss fight in it and everything.
Oh, yeah. Really? Is that how it is? Yeah. You mean the person that gave you the most constructive criticism doesn't get a fucking build of the future build of
you
the game?
You didn't give me any...
I basically helped you alpha test your game and
I gave him input too.
No, you didn't. You just kept...
I did.
You didn't even play the newer ones. I played every single build.
Actually, I did. He gave it to me.
No.
Yeah, he has
you
the
You never
the boss
got the
fight.
High score of 436,500,000.
You... There's not even a scoring system in the game anymore.
I wouldn't know that because you never get it until you played.
Oh, shit.
Because you're a jerk.
Really? Really?
You bring me down.
You hurt his feelings.
I spent so many hours drawing each of those pixels on that asteroid.
Are you doing
that? That asteroid has so many hours into it, and you just called it a cookie crisp.
Because it looks like a cookie crisp. What do you want from me?
You know what I told him?
Show me constructive criticism. Like, hey, maybe you can do this. It'll look better.
Well,
you know
because
what?
You just go, cookie crisp.
You seem very content with the cookie crisp, so I thought you were fine with that. We were joking about it and having a good laugh. You never told me that it was hurting you deep down. How are you gonna do this to me? How are you gonna out me like this on the fucking podcast? Make me seem like the bad guy. All these podcasts, we were sitting there having a laugh and shit, and he's secretly crying and like didn't even tell me about it. Like, you can't do this to me. I'm not the bad guy here. I was having a good laugh with my friend. I thought we were laughing together, but apparently we weren't.
Hey, Justin, guess what?
Yeah.
I never got any new build. I got the same build.
Oh,
you got.
You tricked me, you idiots. You morons, you tricked me. Can't believe you did this to me.
I have the last build.
He has the true build.
You son of a gun. You better send that shit to me.
But no. I gave positive criticism to Bert.
Yeah, he told me stuff like, hey, maybe you should add controller support. The only thing he told me is WASD.
All I told you was add more music to the game. That's a good constructive criticism. You guys can all go back to the previous podcast every single time. I've always told him.
That's the only thing you said. You never said anything
your
good
game
about
was, I told you your game was perfect. Enemy. I told him his game was perfect. Uh-huh. He just needed music. That's all I ever said.
I complimented the AI in Bert's game.
My AI's the best.
It is.
You know, all this talk of Sinistroids is making me hungry for a bowl of Cookie Crisp.
I bet it is.
Mm-hmm. My advice to you, if you're an artist feeling down, don't fucking be a Bert. Don't quit on life and don't and have fucking ambitions and dreams and shit.
Don't quit. Don't follow my example.
Yeah, don't follow Bert.
Don't be Bert.
Don't be Bert. Be a Wolfie. Insult other people's work to make you feel better.
Damn.
Question number two.
Where's my insults for my work? Where's that?
What work?
Damn. Yeah. Fuck you.
Dude, I'm going in today. I'm fucking brutal. Question number two. Now let's get weird. Fuck, marry, kill? Your choices for the randomizer I used are Lara Croft, Samus Aran, Shinoa from Castlevania Order of Iskulskla. Good luck. I mean, good luck.
From now on, if your questions always need to have weird words that he has to pronounce.
No, stop that. I get tongue-tied and alliterated easy.
It's the best.
It's not. So, who wants to go first on this one?
I think Justin should go first.
I will go first. I will be the one. So I will say Mary Samus for the safety.
The safety?
Yeah, the safety. She's super safe.
What about the baby?
No, that's fine. Babies need to die, so... Oh, I should not have said that. I take that back immediately. I'm just going to go ahead and bow out of this question. You guys go next.
Nice. You didn't finish. You only did one.
Okay. Kill Lara Croft because I don't like her. And I guess fuck Shinoa from Castlevania. I hope that's a fucking legal age. I don't even know who that is. I should probably look this character up. I'll be back.
I had to look it up.
I'm going to look this up. Hopefully she's hot.
She is awesome looking.
Let us see.
I know. You did your research, Bert. You didn't even play the game.
I went to go play a game that she was in.
Okay. That's fine. That's totally fine.
Why you hate Lara Croft so much?
She sucks.
Yeah.
What's wrong with her?
She's boring. Who cares?
Must have been all like the death. Death montage or something.
I don't know. She's funny when she dies, so kill her. Mary Samus. Fuck wow. Shinoa from Castlevania Lord of... Next.
Alright, then.
Who's next?
I guess I'll go.
Yeah.
After that,
uh-huh.
You like watching people die. It's
yeah, I do.
Fucked up.
Oh, I just thought about that. That's funny. Oh, that's so bad.
This is a hard choice between who to kill between Lara Croft and Samus.
I thought you were going to say this is a hard choice between who to fuck, and I was going to say that's nice in the window.
I mean... Okay, well.
Yeah.
Because I don't care about either of them. I don't care about any of these, actually, but...
Well, none of us do. That's why it's a randomizer.
Oh.
I guess I would kill Samus.
What?
The only reason...
Why?
It's because she's blonde.
Aw. For those that don't know at home, he's a self-hating blonde.
Looks at his hair in the mirror, and he's like, yeah. I'm dying it red!
I think Shinoa looks cool, so I'll marry her.
Mm-hmm.
Then I guess we'll fuck Lara Croft.
Why?
I don't know. I don't care for Samus.
Let's just throw in that it's a pixelated Lara Croft from the PlayStation era with the pointy, like, polygon. Body.
I don't give a damn.
I mean, are we talking about like pixelated Samus?
Then? Ride those polygons, huh?
Are we talking about pixelated Samus? Like,
sure.
Original Metroid?
Yeah, that's fine.
Well,
I love Metroid in the suit.
So, in video games, this is like going on like underage.
Oh.
It's just wrong.
Metroid is so awesome. He is like awesome.
I love Metroid's missiles.
Why can't he crawl?
Why can't Metroid crawl?
He rolls into ball.
I mean, I guess you'd have some pretty good flexibility, huh?
Oh, yeah. Like you wouldn't believe. Get a good thing going when she goes into morph ball.
I'm gonna stick with my answer.
Okay. Yeah, you will. Suits?
Alright. Mary, Shinoa, fuck, Samus, kill, Lara Croft.
Why are we all different? That's at least something.
I mean, we can all agree Lara Croft needs to die, so 2 out of 3 agree Lara Croft must die.
2 out of 3, Shinoa should be married?
Yeah, that's you too, yeah.
Nice to agree that
because I just know her background, and that is slightly pleasant.
We all had different views on Samus. So there.
I guess that's that.
Yeah. Good ass. Yeah, at least fuck Mary kills. You can never predict them, and even with the research.
Even though she kind of lost her boyfriend, but whatever.
It's fine. It's fine. It's not canon.
It's not canon.
It's not canon. Thanks, Jen the Wolf, for the questions. We really, really enjoy them. And here's the follow-up to what we were talking about last week. This isn't a question so much as it is a comment that I wanted to put on the docket for us to discuss. And it is from HalloFrame, who says... See-through was Nintendo's trademark thing. The brands that came afterward copied this because it appealed to players as a stylish alternative. So to have the viewpoint of it looks cheap, Makes it look like you started playing games when Xbox came out. Not a good look, but I'm not complaining. My first.
I like this guy.
Uh-huh. You would.
Of course.
Uh-huh. I thought it looked cheap when Nintendo did it, and I still think it looks cheap.
Yeah, like
now.
When I say it looks cheap, it was all Nintendo stuff, like N64 controllers and the consoles and all that.
Yeah, the first time I remember seeing it was, I think it was either Game Boy? Was it Game Boy's, not Pocket? It wasn't Pocket.
I had a see-through Advance, the fat one, like crazy long ones.
Oh, those horizontal.
I have one right here.
And
the
I had
Glacier
a see-through
one?
N64 controller that was garbage.
I didn't have an N64 until much later, and mine's a Pikachu N64, so not see-through.
And like, I don't doubt that people like the look of it.
No,
obviously.
No,
that's why they do it.
Our argument isn't that people like it. Our argument is that it looks cheap.
Yeah, we just don't like it.
We don't.
Because everything we've had that's see-through.
I mean, we're the smart ones. Everyone else who thinks it doesn't look cheap is dumb.
I wouldn't go that far.
No, no, that's
again,
pretty much what we're arguing.
You, Justin, you go through things like it's nothing.
That is true. These giant hands were designed for creating.
Everything breaks on you. Dude. Bert, you probably put like pizza, I don't know, pizza, like oil and all bunch of nasty fucking
shit. He does seem like the type that has sticky fingers.
You want to find out?
Then you take your toothpick and then you start cleaning, you know, your controller.
Yeah, I'm the one who cleans the stuff.
That is, but how does it get in there in the first place, Bert?
Your hands sweat.
Dirty hands.
Things happen.
Ew, heads don't sweat. What are you talking about?
Why do you think they had those airflow controllers that had
those
fans in them?
Those things were shit.
They existed for a reason.
See-through air-ass controllers. Those things are awful.
I mean, those were really see-through because they were carved out plastic.
Oh, that's so good.
And those things, like, as I recall, those things that didn't actually help your hand, those things were so novelty and stupid.
They were kind of cool.
You're novelty and stupid.
I am novelty and stupid.
It was fun to use them for a little bit.
What was it?
It was. One of my friends had one.
But we can agree on one thing too.
I had to use it.
But it's okay. We can agree on one thing.
What's
if it's
that?
Not official, it's gonna break. It's gonna break.
I'll give you that one.
I mean, even non-see-through, non-official stuff is probably gonna break.
Yeah, true, but
that is what you call cheap quality.
Yeah, Mad Cats.
I just don't like the look of it because of the way the plastic has to be supported on the inside.
Yeah,
like round
with the little
stuff.
Pillars and the screw. Yes, that's what gets me.
That's how it is without the...
I know, but you don't see it. That's why I say it looks cheap. I'm not saying it necessarily is cheap.
The only cool see-through thing I like is the Sega Saturn one, where you can see the CD spinning inside. Like, the disc thing is see-through, so you can see the disc spinning in it. But I don't have to see the innards of the system.
Well, if you modded your 360 to look that way, then yeah. It exists.
Oh, yeah, you can mod all kinds of stuff to have that.
Yeah, but that was official.
Wouldn't it be dangerous with the laser, though?
No.
No, because the disc would be blocking the...
You could still see the laser through it, though. I know the PS2 did. Because I had that taken apart because it was garbage.
Well,
you still have it, too.
I do. I had to fix that thing so many times. So I never screwed it back together.
You lazy ass.
No, yeah. Lazy. It's just every time I put a disc in, I have to change the angle of the laser.
Wow. You should have just got a new PS2, you idiot.
I did. I got a slim. But the fat one's the only one that has the hard drive when I played Final Fantasy XI.
Oh. Final Fantasy XI, worth getting laser burned over.
Well, you didn't need a disc for that one.
Uh-huh.
Just to install it.
You're dumb. And that is the end of our podcast. Guys... What do you have planned coming up these upcoming weeks?
Well, the next podcast. For me and Scoots, anyway. So there's a new Final Fantasy coming out.
The 15. The road trip, the game.
You too excited for that?
I actually am.
I'm excited to see what it is. I haven't really followed it since it was initially revealed.
There's a lot of positive stuff about it.
I've heard
it.
That.
That's all you need to know.
I've heard that there's been a... Well, obviously, the game got leaked, if anyone didn't know that.
I mean, yeah.
I didn't know that.
So if anyone cares about the story, you can find it online if you want. But yeah, it comes out, I guess, tomorrow, if you want to go.
I gotta test out my PS4 Pro.
Well, the Pro patch doesn't come until December.
It's not until December.
That sounds really good, though. If they can get it up to 60, then that'll be a really nice version of the game.
Do you think they will?
I mean, it's what they're shooting for, but Who knows?
Depends on what we play on, let's say, that day when it releases.
I guess the only other game that's coming out will be Last Guardian, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and don't forget about Dead Rising 4, but you guys can't. Technically, you can play it, Bert. PC version.
Oh, is it coming out same day?
I think so.
Not like a timed exclusive for Xbox?
I think it was PC and Xbox first, and then.
That sounds like a Windows 10 store thing. I don't remember seeing it on Steam.
That sounds like a Windows store thing. Oh. I wonder if that thing's cross buy.
It should be. All those are usually.
Ooh. Stop talking dirty to me. I gotta, like, have a negative thing.
Cross. Oh, man. Does that mean that Platinum game? I guess it would be.
What?
Yep. Scalebound? Scalebound would be Windows 10.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, no. That's not good.
Oh, yeah!
Have we heard anything about that game?
Nope.
Since it was, like...
Nope.
Very negative reception?
Nope.
Scale, man, what the fuck is that?
They're doing the opposite of SEGA, in which they're releasing less and less content about it. They're releasing more demos and shit.
Hmm. Hopefully that turns out good. That's an interesting idea, at least.
Make it faster.
Yes.
I don't know. That game looked kind of dull to begin with.
I guess my week, upcoming week, before the next podcast, I'm going to be doing more Pokemon Sun. I'll be playing Last Guardian if I get that.
Oh, yeah. And I'll be doing Pokemon Moon.
I might see Moana? Moana? Blech.
You too?
The new Disney
movie. The Disney movie.
I might see that.
I know I will.
I'm trying to figure out if I want to see that or Fantastic Beast. I don't know.
Is that animated?
Yeah, it's an animated feature film.
The Rock plays as the main character.
I've never even heard of it.
You remember Lilo and Stitch at all?
Yeah.
It's like, it's based on like Samoan Hawaiian stuff.
So, well, all right then.
Yeah. It looks interesting. I've heard good things about it, so I might give that a look-see. I might actually say that because one of my favorite things, as I told you guys before, as soon as I have a hard-ass day, a shift of work, I go to a midnight showing of a thing an hour early and just play Pokemon, or not Pokemon, play my 3DS until the movie comes on. Then I get to sit there and relax, watch a movie, then go home, and then go to sleep, and then go to work. So I might do that. I'll figure out one, though. I'm also no longer watching Walking Dead. I'm going to find something else to watch.
Watch The Flash.
I guess, yeah. I heard
or
that was
Arrow
good.
Or whatever. When you watch Agents of the Shield, it doesn't matter to me.
I don't know. I just canceled my Netflix because there's nothing I'm really watching on anymore. I've watched everything I wanted to watch on it.
You watch Flash.
Oh, fuck, you're right. It expires on the 8th of December, so I have time. But I'm definitely going to watch the BoJack Horseman Christmas special. I'm really looking forward to that. So, other than that, nothing else on my end. Just work and getting ready for Christmas.
Don't remind me about work.
Yeah.
I'm already on, like, a hate storm of work right now.
Yeah. It's only going to get worse as we approach the other holiday. Black Friday was one thing.
It's going to die down a bit for me, though. I won't have constant, like, two trucks 24/7.
Yeah.
And then management freaking the shit out.
I might get Final Fantasy 15.
Whoa.
I would be very interested. Well,
that would be...
Depends on how it starts. It might be real slow.
I was going to say, yeah, you guys will be... I'm sure whenever you guys get the game, you'll both like send me a message on Twitter being like, you probably shouldn't play this. And that'll be like my first impression. I'll be like, okay. But if you guys are like, maybe give it a shot, I'll be like, okay. You guys will know for me.
If you say so.
It's not turn-based.
I trust your judgment. Don't disappoint me. Next podcast, I will open up whether or not if they have disappointed me or not. Will they disappoint me with their judgments? Find out next time on the 19th podcast of the Monday Night Wolfcast. Thanks for watching, everybody, and have a good morning, night, evening. Bye.